And away we go for today's Sunday Funday Shenanigans, where we hope the laptop doesn't reboot itself like it did last week, because holy crap, what was that? And we're here with Garnet here in Starfield, as we do. And today we are going to be doing various and sundry, along with exploring a theory that, oh, now he's going to pay me to be a murderer. Thanks, dude. Appreciate it. Ka-ching, here's some money. Here's 4,500 credits. How the hell you have 4,500 credits in your pocket? I don't know, but whatever, we'll go with it. Okay, so here we are with Garnet. We have been exploring, we have been doing things with ships, we have been doing this and that and the other, and she's currently wearing Hadrian's outfit with a batball cap because it looks pretty friggin' cool. She looks like a hard-ass explorer. We're going to start today by going to the lodge. We're going to go to the lodge because I have some stuff to drop off. One of the things about being an explorer, as I do as I play this game, is you really don't go back to town very much. You don't go to cities very much. I carry everything I need with me. I don't pick up things I don't actually need. And then once I get to a point where I'm starting to get super encumbered, what I will do is I'll come and dump stuff off in here for later. Like I did, okay, let's go ahead and review where she's at. She's level 134 now. What I have done is I've gotten fitness. I wanted to get some more oxygen, see if this was any good. Turns out for an explorer character like I am, fitness is really good. It is a fucking grind to level up because it's counterintuitive in the way it does its thing, because of course it is. But I've got fitness. I got fitness and weightlifting, and I might be getting wellness next just to get more health. I don't really need it. Groucho, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Little man says hi. He's doing kitty TV out. He's fascinated by the rain outside, so that's pretty good for him. He's been a little shit this week. He's starting to grow into his own, which means he's getting a little bit more bold and a little bit more assertive, but he's still a juvenile cat, so that means he's a little bit wild. Yeah. I also finished up ship command to get 8 people. I finished up isolation, did that. Nothing really else happening here. I can do outpost management, but I don't really care about having more robots, more crew, or producing twice as fast. I just don't care about any of that. In here, nothing has changed. We're still rocking rifles. You've been sick since Friday? Yikes! I hope you're getting better, man. Be on the better side. Good, 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 good. Had a friend over on yesterday, or Friday, and her family's been getting sick. So I'm like, okay, there's a vector. It could happen to me, but we'll just see. Finally got planetary habitation ranked out. Really, the science tree is the one I spend the most time in. And I also started to get astrodynamics, and I'm starting to work into where is it? The fusion one? Where the fuck is it? The one with more... I gotta get this thing going, too. I wanna get this one going. He's getting comfortable. Yeah, he's something. This week, I went ahead and got engine systems up so I could get speed. And this works pretty good. This one's really easy to rank up, which was nice. I haven't done much of anything else in here, though. Just ballistic particle beam weapons, payloads, and starship design. If they ever get off their asses and fix the bug with shield systems, that will be high on my list of priorities to get. I like having lots of shields. But since it's fucking broken currently, and since it's been over 2.5 months and they haven't had a patch out yet, and the one they've got on the beta server is... Oh, I forgot to show you. Doesn't address any of the issues. The constantly sliding power is the broken quest. A lot of the shit, I don't know what the fuck they're doing, but fixing this game is not on their list, apparently. I did get gastronomy. I finally went ahead and ranked this thing up to rank 4. I haven't gotten nutrition. I've gotten just gastronomy. Just so I could make the foods. And that was a fun thing to do. What I've been doing is leaving all my food in here. Basically what I do is I just go out and I just get stuff until I've got... Until my burden is high enough to where I'm like, okay, I gotta drop this shit off. The problem is I don't know what I need still. So I'm basically just picking up everything and sticking it in there. Because, as this game does, yeah, it doesn't really tell you what you need, okay? And I'll show you what I mean in a second. The cooking in particular is half-baked. Half-baked cooking. you have these recipes, yeah? And they need ingredients, yeah? But the ingredients themselves don't tell you what they actually are. So you're like, I don't know what I need. Like when I first started doing it, right? That one stream a couple weeks ago or a month ago or whatever, I don't even remember. The recipe called for red meat. I'm like, what the fuck is red meat? Where do I get red meat from? I don't understand what that is. And it turns out red meat is... is this. Synth meat steak. This is red meat. Okay. I mean, obviously, you look at the package. Duh, it's red meat. Which, that looks like a pretty nicely marbled ribeye. I'm just saying. I would eat that. But if you look up on the top right, it says butcher's best steak made from synth meat, blah, 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 blah. Does not tell you it's used in crafting. Does not tell you it's used in cooking. Does not tell you what ingredient this fucking is. Right? So a lot of the recipes call for eggs. I'm like, what the fuck are eggs? I've never seen an egg. It turns out what they mean is this meal pack eggs. Advanced nutrition standard portion of hard-boiled eggs. Okay. Could you put ingredient eggs on the fucking description so I know what it is? Easy how you doing. Welcome to the stream. Another one it calls for is noodles. I'm like, what the fuck are noodles? I don't know what that means. Is it udon? Is it sochi? Is it soba? Is it fucking spaghetti? What is noodles? I don't know what I need. Yeah. Liquor. Do the Red Harvest things count as liquor or wine? Or I don't know. It doesn't tell you because the ingredients literally don't make any sense. Right? Distilled water, fiber, nutrient. Okay, I can do that. Right? Metabolic agent, membrane, easy. Piece of cake. Right? You go down here, potato. Okay, I've seen potatoes. I know what that is. Bread. Okay, what counts as bread? Basically, anything counts as bread. Naan does not count as bread. But the rye bread, the white bread, the wheat bread, all that counts. Egg. We went over that. Then we have noodles. Okay, which ingredients are fucking noodles? I don't know. So I'm basically forced to pick up every single thing that might possibly be a fucking noodle so I can actually make something. Maddie, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Those are chunks. Yeah. I didn't know that for the longest fucking time, dude. Because on the thing, it doesn't tell you what it is. It doesn't tell you it's an ingredient, yeah? So it's just like... It's another one of those half-baked... Could you guys finish this? Could you complete this system? Could you finish it up? Okay, now I want you to watch this. We have discussed that the safe in your bedroom in the lodge holds an infinite amount of stuff. I want you to watch how it hitches when I roll over it. We're going to go slow, right? And ka-chunk. Because I got so much shit in here, yeah? This is where I put all my survey data. I put my survey data in here, and I put my clothing in here. Survey data, right? And then I go back to clothing, apparel, and I put all the apparel I've got in here. So I can dress my crew members up later on if I want to. Put that in there and that in there. And then what else do I have in this thing? I have notes and miscellaneous, right? Miscellaneous. This is where I put all my toys and the things that I'm saving for, later decoration if they ever finish outposts. If they ever finish outposts, I'm ready. If they ever finish, you know, cosmetics, I'm ready. If they ever finish this, I'm ready. I've got it. We're done. Go ahead and sleep here real quick. But this is the inventory maintenance. Saw the ship pick. Looks good. Yeah, it was my first attempt, yeah? There was an attempt, yeah? That's what they say. That was an attempt. Let me go do that right now. If Aviator comes in later, I'll show him then too. So we've got that. That's all done. Okay. So before we do that, no. Let's not do that. Let's go to the starboard. So we did that. Another thing I wanted to mention too, on the save thing, right? We went over this last week with the things. I only save on travel. Glantry, how you doing? Welcome to Stranger Saying on a tabletop game. All right, man. We will be here if you get done early or whatnot. So turn off all the autosaves except for one. Pick whichever one you want. I pick save on travel because that way when I'm going somewhere, it will save my current progress. I also quick save quite a bit. I only keep 3 hard saves, okay? So I have fewer than 10 saves. An important note, when the game is auto-saving, do not touch your keyboard or controller, okay? If you move while it's trying to save, it will crash every time, okay? Don't move, don't do anything while it's auto-saving. Because they've only had the same engine for 25 fucking years, and apparently they have yet to figure out how to optimize saves and how to make them work. So be advised. When the game goes to autosave, and since I've got it set on travel, I know whenever I fast travel, it's going to save. Whenever I leave my ship, it's going to save. Yeah? Don't touch the controller. Don't touch the keyboard. If you try to move, push any buttons, do anything, it will crash. Because it apparently can't handle 2 things at once. So we're going to go to the ship. You're saving the improvements for TSX. I don't think they are, dude. I'm not gonna editorialize. But what needs to happen, honestly, is they need to spend less time polishing their trophies and more time playing video games that aren't theirs. Okay, autosaving, right? I moved. Now watch. I forgot, and I pushed the button. Watch. Oh, it did it. Okay, this time it worked. 9 times out of 10, it will fucking crash. Yeah, it will crash.
Needs some work. We're asking everyone to... Okay, no problem.
Okay, so let's look at the ships here, yeah? Let's pull this out. So this is the UC prison shuttle that I haven't renamed because I haven't done anything with it. This is the ship that I showed you guys in the Discord last night. We've got, it's got, you know, 4 cannons. It's got 2 missiles. Apparently the missiles don't have to be clear of the landing gear. If you want to look at this here, let's go ahead and ship builder. Let me show you aviator. So here we go. We pull the frame off, right? We got habs. There's habs here. There's habs all along the main line. And there's habs down here. There's habs on both sides. And there's a connector hab up on top of this thing to get inside the ship, right? I tucked the radiator, put the grav drive and the reactor underneath it on the bottom. Yeah. So you can't really see it when you're looking at it from the top. And then on the other side, I put the dock. I didn't want a docking thing on the top, right? So I used the Hope Tech side docker back here with all the back landing gear. Yeah. This doesn't make any sense. It makes perfect sense. You get in the ship from the bottom. So it works, yeah. I mean, it's not perfect, but I needed to have that frame look on the top, right? I tried putting halves down the middle here, but it looked really weird. It didn't really look like I wanted it to. This is definitely going to change. I'm not really very happy with this ship as it is. It's it needs work. It's just too wide. It's too chunky, yeah. Makes sense. Think about TES6. Yeah, they're not going to go too far from the tree. One thing I've been learning about Bethesda as a studio, they don't take risks. They take the safe route, they take the sanitized route, they take the sterile route. They don't innovate, their stuff evolves, but it doesn't really, it's not revolutionary. Like, there's nothing we ain't seen before, you know? And it's just like, hey True, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. But this is the ship, this is my first attempt. It's not very good. I'm not really a big fan of it, but it's there. And then I repainted the peanut, now it's the snowball. I kind of like it in white and blue. Added some more guns to it, and changed the one hab I have to the command center, so I could have 6 crew. I can have 6 crew on this tiny little ship. It's like, yeah, it's gonna be a little bit cozy in there. You think? Yeah. But it's cute. Yeah, it's all right. It's all right. And I still got the Razor Leaf I haven't touched. I got the Frontier that I modded and haven't touched. And the Attitude Adjuster, which is pretty much in its final form. We're not going to be touching this thing anymore. That's pretty much what we got. So that's the ship, yeah? So what I've got here, the ship itself has a capacity of, it says 4725, which is bullshit, right? Whenever you change ships, it forgets you have crew. So all my crew bonuses and all my skill bonuses and shit are just gone, which is, you know, perfect. Good job, boys. Now if I get in the ship, now it's a 5197 where it should be. Now, you look at my capacity, it's like, I have 4131 out of 5197. My ship is getting full. I need to do something about this. I generally don't like to have that much crap in here. When it comes to the capacity, right, all the ship holds is 8 in resources. That's it. And I just save the resources, the aid that's like the bandages and shit, the healing stuff, that's all I save. I don't really use the emergency packs, the emergency kits or the trauma packs, because I don't need them. And I got to get out of this ship, actually. We got to get out again. I got to dump some shit in this fucking kiosk. But basically, I come back to town about once a week just to dump stuff, you know, just to get rid of it. Because like every other game, there is no scarcity here. You will never run out of something. There is, if you do, you can always just go get more. There's no limits on anything. So, let's see, 8. Let's just sell this stuff. 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sell all this. Just sell it all. My balance is only 3.7 because I spent money on that ship that I made. Yeah. Get rid of that, get rid of those, and then we need to get rid of 15 of these, because I don't need this many. I don't know why I keep these, because, I mean, I literally don't talk to anybody, so what the fuck is the point of having them, right? But we'll trim these down to 11, yeah. Get my burden down to 95. Why am I so fucking heavy? Do I have any resources on me? I don't. Oh, the guns. I gotta get rid of the guns. So now when I go to New Atlantis, I basically just get rid of shit, right? I dump crap. I go to the Trade Authority, I go to here. I don't buy anything except 777 just so I can have a huge, huge balance of 777 for my Kadama. Tried using a drum beat. People are saying, oh man, the drum beat's awesome. No, it's crap. Next to the Kadama, it just sucks. It's sloppy, it weaves too much, it's chunky, it's not good. It's not a good gun at all.
Okay, there's Emily. A bit more in the back. If it belongs on your
I
ship,
bet there's a bit more in the back, girl. What up? That's a nice come on line. That's a nice pickup line. So we're gonna buy, let's see, she have any 777 in here? She does, good. Can pad the balance up. But I had this. Well, I gotta put that in my thing here. I had this, I modded it up, yeah? Instigating drum beat. It's just a hunk of shit. I was just completely not impressed with this. This one's pretty cool, you know. It's got rapid and chattering for a shotgun. I don't know if I'm ever going to use shotguns, but if I do, I'm thinking about this thing here. Excuse me, I picked this up somewhere. I don't even remember where I picked it up from. But it's an extended magazine, and it does 552 with no skills. And I'm like, I might start using shotguns. So I'm keeping some shotguns that I'm finding for future 26 fuel rods. Yeah, let's get rid of those. But yeah, this stuff just kind of piles up in the ship. So I sell by the heaviest stuff first because get it out of my thing here. Com relay. Yeah, get rid of those. Modern propellant. Semi metal wafer. Super cool magnet. Molecular sieve. Get rid of those. Get rid of those. Get rid of those and those. Okay. Generally speaking, I don't keep more than 50 of any resource anymore. Yeah. I don't keep more than any of 50 resource. So I've got to do some purging here. What I'll end up doing mostly probably is just dumping it. Literally just jettisoning it. I don't even need it.
Thanks for shopping at Jemison Mercantile.
You're welcome. Now we go down to the well. Go down to the Trade Authority down here. And dump some more crap out of the ship. I probably have too many ship parts. Those tend to pile up when I'm killing ships. Because when I'm out, right, what I do is I keep my burden in my ship really low, so I can just pick things up and not worry about them, and then once a week I'll come back to town and either just dump them or sell them. Not that I really need money, you know? So it's like, whatever. What we're going to do is we're going to talk about Barrett today. We're going to do that first, I think, if this thing ever fucking loads. Okay, good. Yeah, modern game, I'm on a fucking Xbox Series X and it just chugs. We'll go this way.
Ever wonder how the Crimson Fleet
sees? Let's go talk to this chick over here. What up, girl?
The Trade Authority has access to goods and services. Be my guest.
Yeah, Kaminsky, let me see what you got. Sell. So now we go to here. We go to the thing. And aid and ship parts. How many ship... Oh my god, what have I got? Why do I have these in there? I shouldn't have those in there. Got heart in case I upgrade my... med pack, let's sell that. Ship parts. I got 42 ship parts. That's just crazy. I need to get rid of that. I only need like 20. Let's go down to 22. Sell those. And then we're going to go to resources and sort by weight. And start looking for things that are more than 50 and just get rid of them. Yeah, just get rid of them. But this will be a lot of your day because the limits on capacity everywhere are so low that you will spend an inordinate amount of time fucking with these obstreperous 2010 era menus. Yeah. I don't know why this is the way it is, but it's like, could you? But this game's UI is just, it's just bad. It's just really bad. It gets in the way a lot. You have to spend too much time fucking with it. And it loads so slow. I'm like, why does it load so slow? It's the player's in it all the time, you know? And it doesn't have, for some reason, okay, so you're ready for this. In other games, in other Bethesda games, you could use the right and left bumper to move the cursor a little, and you could use the triggers to move it a lot. But in this game, the triggers zoom the thing on the inventory screen. Why can't I? Never mind. Because they didn't play test it. Yeah. Because they didn't really consider the player's needs or really worry about that too much because, you know, Lowest common denominator, take no chances, make it nice and safe and sanitized and make it palatable to everybody and blah, blah, blah. And it's just like, okay. So I just have to sit here and wear out my shoulder buttons to sell things. Okay, sure. Meanwhile, the triggers, which should work to move the cursor in large chunks. God damn it. It's still sorted by weight. Okay, good. So basically, I just go down and I trim everything down to 50. Yeah, this is what we do. This is the compelling gameplay that you've come here for, yeah? Because the shit just piles up, yeah? And I got to get rid of it, right? But I do need it for crafting. So when I do need it for crafting, I want it on hand. Because there's no universal inventory except in your ship. So you're limited by the amount of stuff that you can hold. But I want to have capacity, right? I want to have extra capacity to pick stuff up and give things out. Like, sometimes I'll just need to craft an adaptive frame. I don't want to sit here and go back to town to buy nickel. I'm like, fuck it, I'll have it on hand. But I don't have too much because I have to carry that shit around, right? Because these things are all obnoxiously heavy. And there's no perks that will allow you to lower the burden of these things. I mean, yeah, you can increase your storage capacity with the payload skill, but that's not as effective as reducing the weight of the shit in the first place, right? So, seems odd. A lot of it seems odd. Disjointed, unfinished. You get that a lot, yeah? And the more you play the game, the more obvious and glaring these oddities become, to where they start to become frustrating, because you're like, why am I doing this so much, and why can't I just, you know, why can't I have somewhere where I can just send this stuff, you know, like, say, a transfer container in my outpost. Give me a reason to build outposts, right? Give me a vendor at my outpost. Let me build a terminal that just lets me dump this shit. Give me 50,000 credits, just let me dump this crap so I can get on to playing the game. But apparently they think fucking around in spreadsheets and dicking around with the UI is compelling gameplay. Because otherwise, it doesn't make sense. Because you should review a lot of it. Yeah? I have tried to get it to the point where I don't have to worry about it as much. But I still have to do this once a week. You know, or you stop picking stuff up. I could do that, sure. But because technically I don't need it, so I don't really need to be picking it up. But sometimes it's nice to have the stuff on hand when I'm in the field, just in case. I'm going to save those. 15 of these. I don't know what this stuff is used for. I think it's for building furniture or something. I don't really know. But it's just with a compelling... Yeah, with the zoom feature. Why zoom in a sale menu, dude? I just need to sell stuff. I don't care. I've got the name of it. I know what I'm trying to sell. Jesus. You can get rid of a lot of that. Get rid of 61 of those. Get rid of 18 of these. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff in here where it doesn't really makes sense, where it's obstreperous, just it's finicky and fiddly for the sake of being finicky and fiddly. I mean, there are some people, sure, that just enjoy moving things around in spreadsheets. I mean, that's their entertainment, that's their gameplay, I guess. More power to them. But get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of those, get rid of that, that, and that. And it's a sealant stalk, sealant root, you know, gland and seed and whatever the fuck. Why are you making the distinction? What's the difference? There's no difference. So just call it all sealant. Can you just call it all sealant? What? Why would... Whatever. Aid. Okay, we're good. I'm not going to fuck around this somewhere.
The Trade Authority appreciates
But thankfully, I only do that shit once a week. Okay, let's quick save so we don't have to do that anymore. Yeah? Let's quick save so we don't have to do that again. Okay, don't touch the controller. Don't move. Let the game work on quick saving. Because, again, 25 years, they haven't figured this out. I'm thinking the problem is the reason it has such problems saving and crashing because there's too many dinosaur bones cluttering up the code. That would be my guess. Okay. So let's talk about Barrett. Let's talk about Barrett. And my theory. Let's talk about the theory. Okay, spoilers for you. If you care about spoilers, I'm going to warn you right now. We're going to be going heavy into spoiler territory right here. Okay. I'll give you a couple more seconds to bail out, change your mind, make sure you know what's going on. Yeah. I am about 80% sure that Barrett is a Starborn. I'm about 80% sure that Barrett is a Starborn. There are some things that don't quite make sense. Okay. So we're looking for the Nira system right now. NIRAH. It's around here somewhere. NIRH. It should be pretty close as I recall. Because there were some things that they... Nicola, Leviathan, Lunara. Where is Nira? Cheyenne's up there. Castlehag. Sure would be nice to have labels on these things so I could just click a button and see all the names of the stars so I can know where I'm going, but, you know, it'd also be nice to have a fucking... It would also be nice to have a goddamn, It'd be nice to have a, What the fuck is Nira? Starfield first box. No, they won't do that. I mean, I have a suspicion the limited nature of the inventory is due to it being a pseudo survival game, because that would make an actual little bit of sense. But apparently they had a survival mode and they gutted it or changed it late in development, and oh boy does it show. So you get all these mechanics that don't quite make sense. Where the fuck is Nira? It'd be nice, like I said, if I could just click the left bumper and just get the labels of the stars on here. Yeah. In 2023, I can have my phone tell me exactly where to go. In 2330, I have to sit here like a medieval dude with a fucking sextant trying to figure out where the fuck the systems are that I'm trying to find. Where the hell is Nira, dude? That's serious. Let me start Procyon B. Okay, I need to find the Nira system. NIRH. Wilfred Celebri, Tadacha, Heisenberg, Copernicus, Dekarin, Sada. But yeah, this is the type of UI that someone who enjoys fucking around in spreadsheets for the sole purpose of fucking around in spreadsheets would enjoy. I'm not seeing it. I don't know where it was, but it should be pretty close. Is it down here? It's not down here, is it? No, that's Alpha Terna. And of course, the flyover menu that covers what you're looking at. Instead of moving the map over to where I can see what the fuck is behind it, no, it just covers it up, because that's just the laziest, cheapest way, the fastest way to do it. Yeah. Tau Ceti, Sirius. Where the fuck is Nira, man? This is Bessel and Piazzi, right? Yeah, I've been there a lot of times. Altair, Bernard Star, Wolf, Nurian Valo. If any Starfield players know where Nira is, could you give me a clue where it might be? Because, I mean, I literally can't find it. And rolling this thing over 100 fucking stars trying to find the place that I know where I want to go. I just can't put a fucking marker in there selected from a codex. No, why would you be able to do that? That would be intelligent. That would make sense. That would be something that a navigating thing would use. In Narian? It's in Narian? Okay. Let's see. Sumati. It's a moon. I know it's a moon, right? Is it a moon? So I'm looking for the Kazal. I'm looking for the Kazal. Podius, Danra, Crete, Victera is there. Nira. No, not this Nira. No. Not NIR, not the mech place. It's a system called NIRAH. I'm looking for the Kazal mine. The Kazal sulfur mine. I was there last week. Yeah? And I saw it. And when I went through the logs on the terminals, that made me go, huh, what the fuck is going on here? And that's when I started to think about Barrett being a Starborn. Because some of the things that happen don't make a lot of sense. Okay, this is fucking crazy. Where the hell is the goddamn thing? Why can't I just fucking look at the goddamn labels and find what I'm looking for? Why does this have to be so fucking difficult? Because that's the thing, I know it's out here, and I know I've been to it, but I've got no way to select it other than sitting here doing this fucking hunt and peck bullshit. Okay, fuck it. We're just going to go through every star one by one, because we can't put names on any of them. We can't label them until we actually hover over them, because why would we be able to do that? Where the fuck is it, dude? No, there's no search option. There's no codex. There's no index. There's absolutely no way to find a system unless you know where it is, and you know. But this is their method of locating systems. Okay, guys, I gotta look this up. I'm sorry. This is fucking insane. This is literally fucking insane. I can't. Hold on a second. I'm waiting for it to go over here. Come on, give me the cursor. Where? Oh god damn it, Google. Thanks for popping up a bunch. Where is Nera? RH Starfield. Nera star system. Where the fuck is it? Show me where it is. It is near on the star map. It is. Oh, that's a tiny thing. Thanks, man. Where is it? Copernicus, Crix, Ophion. Where the fuck is it? Okay, great. Okay, so it's up to the right of Ophion. So it's Crix. Crix is here. Then it goes to Copernicus. Then it goes to Ophion, which is here. That's Bannock. Bell. Mal. Ophion. Where the fuck is Ophion? Crix. Ophion. It's over up here somewhere. That's Strix. I can't tell where this fucking thing is, man. It's apparently over here somewhere. Yeah. But given that you can't pan and scroll this thing in any real way, you can't really. Sparta. Okay, I'm looking at this map. Cheyenne. Okay, so Cheyenne's there and Crix is there. There's three dots there. And this is the worst part. I've got the map up on this. Oh, there's Ophion. Okay. There's Ophion. So it should be right there. Okay, finally we found it. Had to fucking Google it, but what the hell, right? It's up by Jaffa. Alright, that's cool. Alright, we got it. So let's go back to talking about what we were talking about, yeah? This is what I mean by not really paying attention to the player. Paul! How you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. Hey, eat a dick. Alright, we're all done. Look at that, my shield, and of course it resold all my power settings because they can't figure out how to fix that shit. It's like the whole thing. I mean, I don't know how they played this for more than about 20 minutes before thinking, oh, this is fine. You know, that they just didn't listen to their fucking testers. I don't know, dude. I really don't know. That's pronounced Nera, not Nera. Thanks, Ogre, that was really helpful, man. But it's like, it needs about another year in the maybe another year in the oven is what it needs, right? Is Starfield worth the money? String, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Right now I would say no. Get it on sale. Donna, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. It's by Charybdis. It's not that far out. It was pretty far out though. Yeah. But yeah, there's no codex, there's no list of stuff, there's no index, there's no journal, there's nothing. Yeah. I mean, it's a fun game, don't get me wrong, but is it worth $70? I can't agree with that. Okay, so let's go back to the whole thing. Spoilers, if you're new, we're talking about spoilers now, okay? We had a little interlude where I couldn't find a fucking system because there's actually no Google Maps or any kind of index or search feature or anything in this game at all. Okay, sure. Back to the original. Let me catch up. Is it worth the money? Not right now, it isn't. No. Wait for patches. Wait for them to fix it, String. There's a lot of shit that's missing. A lot of shit that doesn't work. There's a lot of stuff that doesn't make any sense. A lot of the quests just tail off into nothing. There's no real recognition of most of your actions from anybody. There's no awareness of what you're doing. There's no cross-quest. There's very little cross-quest pollination. They have a background system that's like haphazardly implemented that's just flavor text. It's just like all the pieces are here, right? Somebody described this as like they're selling you a house, right? It's got a really solid foundation, it's got really solid frame, and it's got a roof. And that's it. We're gonna add the walls and the carpet and the appliances and the furniture and the pipes and the electric. We're gonna add all that shit later, but for right now you could sleep in this house. Okay, that's good. I'm not gonna pay full price for that though. You need to finish the rest of it. You need to fill in the shit, right? And it's from a theme perspective, it's very, very sterile. It's very sanitized. It's very, very PG-13. Not even PG-13, because in PG-13 movies, you can say fuck. They don't say fuck in this thing. Okay, so back to that. I basically, String, what I would recommend is watch some other streams from a variety of streamers. Yeah, and because they do different shit, right? I like exploring. Yeah, I like exploring. And this game is really this game is adequate at that. You can say that about a lot of its systems. It's adequate. Yeah. It's like a bowl of plain oatmeal. Okay. If you're hungry, it'll fill you up. And it's pretty good for you. Right? So you're going to get nutritional value and you're going to get your hunger sated. It does the job. Okay. Will you remember it in 3 hours? Is it tasty? Are you looking forward to the next bowl? No. It does the job. Right? It's a good filler. But that's all it is. It's just filler. There are moments, like in Bethesda games, right? I'm sorry, I'm just sitting on a screen. I'm just editorializing here. In Bethesda games, you have this whole, I'm going to wander around and I'm going to run across something cool. I don't know what it is. I don't know where it is. But there's all kinds of, the worlds, the play area is full of stuff, right? So you wander around Skyrim, you wander around Fallout 4, you wander around Fallout 3. You know the odds are pretty good you're going to stumble across something that has a background, has a story, there's something that happened here. You'll be all, there's all these dead bodies, what the fuck happened here, right? That's what they excel at. This game doesn't have that at all. That whole dynamic is just gone. That whole exploring and finding cool shit that you don't know what it is doesn't exist in this game. Okay? When you land on a planet, you get markers to tell you where things are. So you just go straight to the marker. You don't see anything on the way that's unusual, that's noteworthy, that's exciting, that makes you wonder about. It's nothing. It's like, okay, let's go to this place. Yeah? And it's just detached. But exploring is good, right? Sitting down on a planet, wandering around, looking around shit, fun as hell. The artists are amazing. There's no unmarked locations that I've ever seen. I've explored 300, 400 planets, scanned about 700. Haven't ever stumbled across something that I didn't expect to see. Yeah. Other than, you know, the random bugs and shit, and maybe there's some terrain that looks pretty cool or whatever the fuck. But it's not something that you think about 3 days later going, man, that was really fucking cool. Sounds like the perfect canvas for mods. It sounds like the perfect canvas for mods. It sounds like the perfect canvas for licensing this fucking IP. You watch. They're going to license the shit out of this IP. No kid in the fridge? No. No kid in the fridge. Well, if there is a kid in the fridge, Dalton, it will be a marker when you land that says unknown. You click on it, it says kid in the fridge. You're like, okay, let me just go over there and see what that is. You won't stumble across it, right? You can't accidentally find it, right? You know what I'm saying? It would be different if you landed on a planet. Because the draw distance is like 2 kilometers in this game, right? If I get up high, I can see every point of interest forever, right? So I'm like, okay, I'll go over there. So I start walking my way over there, and an icon pops up. It's like, oh, there's something here. I'm like, I know there's something there. I can fucking see it. But it, like I said, it assumes you need a mouth guard and a helmet to get through life, yeah, with your safety guardrails on and everything. So whatever. Okay, anyway, enough of that shit. Sting, watch other streams, get other opinions on different styles of gameplay. There might be something in there that you like that I don't do, which is probably pretty likely. And get a better feel for it. Don't just take my opinion. Don't just take my word for it. This is what I have seen based on how I like playing these games and what I'm looking for in entertainment. Yeah. Okay, so back to Barrett. Okay, we're going to stop here first. So Barrett, when you first start the game, right? You go in with Lynn, you go in with Heller. She's got a job from Barrett. Yeah, you don't know Barrett yet. She said the client wants this thing. I've got this scanner that shows me where this thing is. I know what signs to look for. The gravitational anomaly is how they find these artifacts, right? Because around every artifact, gravity is just kind of not there, right? So there will be when they scan a planet or a system or whatever for gravitational fields, there's an anomaly. There's a hole where these artifacts are. That's how they find them. Lynn knows Heller has got a tool that tells him where these are, right? And Lynn has gotten the assignment from Barrett to pick this up, to find this thing. So you go in, stupid newbie, cut the shit away from it, grab the artifact, have a vision or whatever the fuck, black out, wake up. You say, I don't remember anything. You're like, whatever. So you go, you meet Barrett.
Yeah.
We did this in the first stream. You go meet Barrett. Barrett says, I'll read this location. Barrett says, oh, you got the vision. You did this, you got that, whatever the fuck, right? And the way he talks, right? I didn't think about this at the time. But the way he talks about it, you get the sense that he's really familiar with this.
Yeah.
That he's has some experience with these artifacts, has some experience with the acquisition of them and the visions and the blacking out and the whatever, right? As a newbie, you don't think about it. You say, okay, he just knows. When he's talking to Lynn, he's like, remember that dig we did on Kazal or Bindi or whatever thing? He said Bindi. She says Kazal. Okay. If you go to Bindi, there is a Six Sisters mining outfit, but there's nothing there. There's no terminals, there's no slates, there's no nothing. It's just a normal, plain old Six Sisters. We dig rock. I like the Six Sisters. I would like to work with them. And so then I'm like, okay, I'm going to go to Kazal. The sulfur mine in Kazal, right? Yeah, whatever, dude. Gotcha. Don't stick your head out, dumb fuck. So I went to Kazal. I saw Kazal, and I'm like, huh, I remember that. So when I went to Kazal, it was very, come on. There. So I wanted to go to Kazal and look around. Yeah? Because this is where Barrett picked up the artifact. Okay. Why would Barrett get them mixed up? Other than him being a total dipshit. Right? Because Barrett is a Starborn. And in one of his earlier universes, the first artifact was on Bindi. Here, it was not. Here, it was a Kazal. God damn it. There. Fuck you, dude. Oh, the AI is trash in this game, too. So, if you like engaging combat sting, this is not a game you want to play. People with actual skill go very hard as a joke. It's so stupid. So I got to thinking about it. I'm like, why is, what's at Kazal? So we go to Kazal. I want to see, you know, what I can see. Barrett's first, you know, artifact, whatever the fuck. But I'm thinking that this is not Barrett's first, shot him in the shin there, by the way. If you look, those little railings, yeah, have a hole in the bottom, a little slit in the bottom, and you can see their legs through it, and it is transparent. So you can shoot them in the shin and kill them through the, yeah, whatever, dude. Shut the fuck up. Whatever. Eat a dick. Where you at? Come on, homie. Light you on fire there. Yeah, you have it. Yeah, that's some AI, huh? So I was like, okay, well, why does Barrett think it's at, why does Barrett think it's at, it was a Bindi? Why is he confused? Right? So then I started thinking, how many artifacts did they have before I showed up? Something you really don't think about at the beginning of the game, right? Because it's all new, and you're like, oh, look at this, look at that, whatever the fuck. Oh, I don't need that fucking advanced mag shear. I forgot to go chop off those guns. I'll do it later. So when you go to the thing for the first time, Barrett seems to know quite a bit about these artifacts. And you're like, okay, where did they come from? Yeah, you don't really know where they came from, right? The first one, according to Mateo, was in a container, a storage container in Constellation. Sat there for years. Nobody knew what it was. Yeah. And they only recently found it, right? After they found it, Barrett pulled the second one in from Kazal very quickly. Like, oh, what a coincidence that is, that he just managed to happen across this fucking thing. Oh, and if you're curious, this is a sulfur mine. This is sulfur getting stacked up, and it's just abandoned here. But if you go over to here, is it here? Where was it? It was... God damn it. But anyway, I started thinking about it. I'm like, okay. So here's the thing. Let me give you a little visual aid here. Okay. When you first get the Constellation, this is how many they have. They have two. They have one that was in the basement of Constellation and the one that Barrett brought back from Kazal. Okay. If you are a scientist or an analyst or a statistician or a mathematician purposes, you will know that a single data point, it's kind of impossible. It's very unlikely to draw any real conclusions from a single data point. Okay. So you start thinking to yourself, okay, they had one, Barrett got the other. How did he find it? The artifacts, as we know, only are active. They are only active when you first pick them up, right? After they are picked up, they could be transferred hand to hand, moved around, whatever the fuck. Nobody gives a shit. Okay, they're just inert metal. They're not anything special. It's only when you first pick them up that you get the visions. Okay, this is the entrance, by the way. I really wanted to go down in the mines and see where the first artifact was, but this is where this is where Shaft A is. You can't go in there. It kind of blows. Kind of disappointed about that, but that's not the first disappointment this game had. Probably won't be the last. But then I got to Kazal, and I'm like, okay, I didn't think about all this shit before, right? Didn't even occur to me. Didn't even think about it. But. Oh, I love this game's movement physics. Still locked in 1998. Nikita, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Alright. So, I went to Kazal. Okay, all this stuff I've been telling you right now, I didn't think about this at all. Didn't even occur to me to look into it or anything. But then I came to Kazal. Okay. And in Kazal, up here, as we spend our time running, because we do a lot of that, they should call this the Chariots of Fire simulator. When you go up here, you go up in this thing. Let me see if I can find it again. I think it's up here. Is it up here? No, it's over there. Is it over there? Where the fuck is the office? I know it's... So anyway, this is a big old Argos... This is a big old Argos extractors mining facility. Yeah? And there's a lot of equipment here, man. This is a big-ass fucking place. Yeah? There's a Varun Zealot. Now watch. Watch me run up to him and just stand there. Look at... They're not even aggroing, dude. Look at this. That is some high-quality AI. How do you think, right? Sitting there just literally running up, foot stomping, and I just walk right up and shoot him in the face. Yeah. If you like advanced combat, skip this game. It is not difficult at all. Okay, here we go. So we go in here. Is it here? Yeah, it's gotta be here. Anybody else in here? Yeah, look at him. Look at him. Just look at him. Staring at me. I literally walk up to him, dude, and he doesn't even alert until I'm, like, literally, I'm literally in melee range. Oh, man. I'm not even going to talk about it anymore. All right, let's see if we can find this fucking place. Because there is... Yeah, whatever, dude. Ah, it's over there. No. Whatever, dude. I don't even give a shit. Hang on, I'm looting your buddy. Where'd you go? I mean, you can feel pretty heroic because, I mean, you're basically unfucking killable, right? Even a crappy shot like me does pretty good with this stuff, huh? Right? Particle fuse junk plush, right? What the fuck? You have two weapons on you? Two of the same. Calibrated. Level 134, I'm getting calibrated shit, so. Okay. Sure, Jam. Will you? I'm gonna watch you burn. Yeah, I like that. Oh, who's left? One more over here. Where you at, homie? Okay, shut up. I don't need impact grenades. But yeah, there is a I'm just walking through here, fucking body checking them, and I'm like, I lost a little health there. Oh no, guess I have to use a med pack now. All right, Lynn, where is your fucking computer? Let's go on with our thing. But this, reading this, let's open the door. This opens the door down there, right? Yeah, open the door. Thank you. It opens that door down there. That's the loot room, yeah. Let's go see if we got any good loot. It's on easy, so probably nothing good. Yeah, I don't even, I'm not even gonna look at it. I know it's shit. Can I grab those? Exterminator advanced? Yeah, whatever. Exterminator's trash. This is trash. Nothing in here. Nothing in there. Smoked salmon fillet, not used for anything. This is trash. Okay, cool. Alright. But you notice I'm not really picking up anything, right? I'm picking up ammo. Picking up ammo, and I'm picking up meds. And that's pretty much it. Okay, Lynn. Where is your computer terminal? Or is your office up here? Okay, here we go. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's a 4 and 4. We have to do 4 and 4. This one has to go here. So now we need a 4 that's kind of spread out. This one? I need those two holes right there. I need these two holes right here. So it's got to be that one. Yeah. And then here we've got... Okay, that's the middle one. So we're going to place this one right now if we can. It's right there. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. It's got to be that one. It's this one here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. Okay, so we got that set up. So now this one here has three holes, right? I know that you have to use two keys every time. So this is going to be any two and a one, right? So it could be this two. We'll go with that two. We'll see if that works. We'll go with that two and a one. And then we know this one is going to be that one and this one. And this is two and two, right? So now we go two there and two here. But see, it tricks you on these, right? Because you think, oh, it's two and two. It's not. It's three and one. But it can't be three and one, right? It can't be three and one, so it has to be two and two. So it's got to be this one and that one. All right, let's see what we got here. There's a cot. A dead robot behind the door. The door is master locked. Why is he dead and behind the door? I don't know. St. Lynn's office, though. Okay. Okay, where the fuck was Lynn's office? This is a kitchen. Nothing really in here. Older save kits kept crashing. Yeah, that's what it does, Paul. I mean, that's why you got to keep the number of things you have in your inventory low. That's why you don't keep a lot of saves, because even keeping a lot of saves will fuck it up sometimes. It sucks, man. I've had to restart. I've had corrupted saves now. Even with all my militant pruning down of the let me just stand here and shoot you in the face. Yeah. Lead line shock troops get packed. Trash. Okay. We don't even pick up legendaries. Why? They're just a waste of time. Rares, epics, legendaries, just waste. What they really should need to work on, though, I'm thinking, is the bloom and the lighting. Something's fucking broken with bloom. I personally dislike that element as a game feature in general, because it's like, oh, well, when you go from a blind place to a dark place, your eyes would normally dilate. I'm like, they do. I'm looking at the television. They're dilating now as it is. I don't need the game faking it out. But the reason the bloom fails so bad, look at how much light's in that room. See how well lit that room is right now? You're like, okay, pretty cool. As soon as I walk through the door, really? It gets darker the closer I get to the lights? Really? what happens is their bloom code is fucked up. Yeah. And it's adding these effects to it where it shouldn't. Yeah. Basically, it doesn't know where the player is, and it's doing it backwards. I mean, I guess this is supposed to be thematic or whatever the fuck, but it just turns out being stupid, because I'm looking at this fucking thing. Looks like the inside of a grocery store. I go in here, and I'm in a fucking cave, and I look outside, and it's pitch fucking black. But if I walk out the door, now it's brighter at night. What? I mean, that's the kind of thing, if you'd playtested your game, you would have found out. You'd figured it out. But, well, here we are. God damn it, where the fuck is Lynn's office? Let me turn the light on. Let me turn my flashlight on, because none of the lights actually illuminate anything. Oh, Christ. Okay, so there's the outside. Come on, man, where the fuck is Lynn's office? I know it's in here somewhere. But you see the bunk rooms, right? These people are going to be here for a long fucking time, right? They were settling in for the long haul. And now it's all abandoned and whatever. Maybe it's downstairs. I guess it's downstairs. Let's go back downstairs. Again, nice and brightly lit. Yeah. Another year. This is what it should look like all the time. This is what it should look like all the time. Yep. All right. Let's turn my light back on. And go through here. Here's those. But yeah, something is definitely broken with their bloom or their lighting code. Okay, here we go. So here is the cavernous pit that Lynn worked in, because this is Supervisor Lynn's terminal. Okay, so here's the history of Kazal, and this is how Barrett knew Lynn. Another rare minimal contact. Barrett and his New Atlantean social club paid for discretion, so were mining sulfur. Okay. Okay. So, Constellation is paying Argos to send Lynn out here to set up all this fucking equipment, hire all these fucking people, get all this stuff going, just to cover up the fact that he's looking for the artifact, the anomaly they're after, actually turns up. 20 days, 3 shifts a day, right? That's how long it took to get the sham facility. The amount of money this Constellation group is spending must be astronomical. The scanning technology alone looks like it was stolen from a UC skunk works. Whatever this anomaly is, it must be worth a fortune. Though if it's that valuable, it'd explain why they don't want anyone to know what they're looking for in the first place. The scanning technology alone looks like it was stolen from a UC skunk works. Let's back up to that first data point. They have one that was in the basement. At this point, right now, in Lynn's timeline, in the timeline of her writing these logs, okay, Constellation has one artifact that they dug up from a box in the basement, okay? Barrett is looking for the second one, which is the first one any living Constellation member is going to find. The scanning technology alone, scanning technology, he knows how to scan for them. How does he know how to scan for them? Not only does he know how to scan for them, but he knows how to make a machine that will scan for them. Okay? And according to Lynn, this is looks like experimental technology. It's really advanced technology. Where did he get the information for this? How did he know to build this? How did he know to scan for it? How did he know to configure it? First merges the evac, forms able to get that. She's working with Heller. Went back to the fucking thing to get the thing. Brunzel's come in. We found it. We've been looking for a mineral anomaly, a piece of metal or rock that stood out. But it was a dip in gravity. Scans of the spot showed the exact signature we'd been told to look for. Again, they only have one artifact. And the artifact they have doesn't show up as anything on scans, right? Yet she's talking about an anomaly, which is the anomaly of an artifact in its resting place, which is a thing, right? Gravitational anomalies are a feature of the intact in place. How the fuck did they know how to do this? When they've got that, you got to collect Barrett. That's a wrap. The anomaly's found in our point. I escorted Barrett to the site, and the two of us went down to collect it. He says, could be dangerous down there. Why don't you head back to the hab? Right? Customer's always right. Turn back. We waited and waited and waited. He comes back after a couple of hours. Find it. What do you? He had the vision. He's grinning from ear to ear because he knew what he was going to find down there. He tells them stay back because he knows he's going to pass out. But if he's not a Starborn, this is literally the first time any human has ever encountered one of these things. How the fuck does he know all this? Closing up shop, Constellation. Okay. So that's when I read that, I started thinking, I'm like, he knew what the scanner anomaly was. He knew how to create a machine that would scan for it. He knew where to look for it. He knew how to get to Kazal in the first place to find its resting spot. And he got it mixed up with Bindi a couple of times. Because when you go through the Unity, the artifacts aren't all in the same place. Yeah. So, how did he know? Does data slates count towards unique items? Yes, they do count towards unique items, and yes, you should store them in the lodge, Paul. That'd be my recommendation. That's what I would do. That's what I've been doing. Because there's so many slates. Yeah, there's so many survey data slates. So here we are, right? You're like, okay, I have a lot of questions for you, Barrett. How did you know? If this were literally your first time through, if this were literally the first time you have an artifact, the data you would need to find another would come from the first one that you found, but you can't do that because that's not how they work. Yeah. So yeah, man. Now, there are some problems with it. And then, of course, when you fight with him, he says things like, I've done all this a lot of times before. I bet you have, Barrett. And if you've done the high price to pay and Barrett doesn't die, right? If Barrett isn't the one that gets killed, if it's Sarah or Sam or Andresia, you go to the wake, the memorial service or whatever, right? And people give speeches. Walter gives a speech, Mateo gives a speech, and Barrett gives a speech. Barrett's view of death, right? And how he's not mourning because blah, blah, blah. What he describes in his eulogy is basically what it's like to go through the Unity. It's literally what he's talking about. Because when you get to the Unity, your future you tells you all this shit. Yeah? Barrett already fucking knows. How does he know all this? Because he's a fucking Starborn. The only place where it breaks down, the only place where the theory breaks down, is when you kill a Starborn, they evaporate. Right? You kill a Starborn, if they're not in their original universe, they just evaporate into like a little pulse of light. You get a quantum essence and whatever. Yeah? If Barrett dies, his corpse is still there. Right? So you're thinking, well, he can't be a Starborn. Well, here's the thing. If you kill the Hunter or the Emissary, they don't despawn right away either because they have loot on their bodies you have to get. Yeah? They have loot on their bodies. In this case, it's the artifacts. Right? So what if Barrett has something on him that prevents his body from doing that? What if he's got a little shard of artifact or whatever that doesn't go away? Starfield story is human hunting from their parents. Starfield story is best not thought about too much. Again. Basically, the magic MacGuffin is you turn into a dragonborn with star powers and can do shouts, and you go through the multiverse, and you can go on to... You can go through this thing called the Unity, which is like the center of the multiverse, like some kind of tram or whatever. And it just takes you to a universe that's 99.99999% similar to this one. It's not... I mean, there's a whole other meta discussion we can have about artifacts being basically a prison rather than, you know, this mind-altering, futuristic, whatever the fuck. There's a lot of problems with it from a real science fiction story. But then again, it's magic and Gandalf and fucking rainbows and ponies and shit, so who fucking knows what they're doing? But this is why. This is why. If it's ever revealed that Barret is a Starborn, I'm not going to be surprised. Okay? Then the question I have is, was all that deliberate or was that accidental? Given the quality of writing throughout this thing, I'm going to say it's accidental. But Barret is a previous... worse than previous Bethesda games. Yeah, yeah. Because in previous Bethesda games, what you did mattered. Here, it just doesn't. Okay, I gotta go to Barret. I gotta drop some stuff off, guys. I gotta go to my thing here. But anyway, there's my evidence and my theory. My evidence to support my hypothesis that Barret is a fucking Starborn. So if you play the game with that in mind, which I intend to do at some point, I'm gonna watch what he does and says a lot more closely. Because I'm thinking, child looks for parent looks for kid, human looks around, yeah. I guess the goal was, what I can't do, little man's, what are you doing, dude? You can't climb up my lap. Little man's is actually on his co-pilot pad. So we're getting there. Nice hitch there, huh? All done.
United Colonies vessel to unknown contact.
Yep.
We weren't expecting the ecliptic. I have a lot of my crew over here.
Yep.
Any
yep.
way we can repair.
Oh, by the way, you don't get the reward if any of them die. I found that out the other day.
That can be arranged. We got to resume our...
If you just fuck around out here and let them die so you can loot them, they will not give you rewards. Which, I mean, is fair. It's fair. But this one here, the story is just... Basically, you search for the artifacts. When you find all the artifacts, you find out from the hunter and the emissary that there's a multiverse, and that we've all done this millions of times before, and you can hop to a new universe and get a fresh start and a clean slate and whatever the fuck and blah 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 blah. But the universes you go to is 99.999% the same. Okay, literally. The only things that change are the main story and how Constellation Net reacts to you, and there's like 11 different alternate starts. But they don't change much of anything. Yeah. There's no real difference between all the universes. Which is its own meta, in a way. Because that implies that there are an infinite number of universes and infinite combinations, but you only have access to like 12 of them. Yeah. Because a lot of it's predicated on... Let me put it to you this way. You will never go to a universe where there are no artifacts. Think about that one for a minute. You feel with the stories and plans, have you ever messed around with the Red Dead Redemption 2? Yeah, I did, but I got... The thing about that missed me is, Rockstar is one of those companies that I can see their games, yeah? I can watch playthroughs of them. I can see that their fucking high-quality games are amazing, you know? They got all this amazing shit in them. They just don't hook me. I don't get them. I get bored of them very, very, very fast, and I don't know why. It's consistent, right? They're high-quality games that I just don't understand. I've never been able to just, like, get into them, yeah? And I tried GTA 4, I tried GTA 5, I didn't try GTA Online, because why? And I did play Red Dead Redemption, the first one, all the way through. I did complete that one. But the second one, I played through the intro in the hills looking for the guy. And then we got out to the thing and we got the camp in the town. And then Josh says, okay, time for you to get a job. And I'm like, all right, I'm out. I already got a job. I don't need another job. But yeah, like I said, they're high quality games that I just don't understand. That's why I'm getting excited about GTA 6. I'm hoping that GTA 6 will be the GTA game that I'm actually interested in. Because the only one that I've been interested in before this is San Andreas. I didn't like any of the others. Like, none of them. I need to go to Vessel 3B. So what we do is put this up. Unselect that. Put this up. Where's vessel 3B? There's 3A. Here's 3B. Let's go to 3B. Travel. The world building. Yeah, Rockstar, man, their games from a technical perspective are almost impossible to beat. Yeah. That's why people were saying, oh my god, GTA 6, what's Bethesda gonna do? Well, nothing, dude. They're not even in the fucking same league. They're not even playing the same game, dude. The only thing you could say is they haven't commented their video games. Who are you? You are Vanguard Destroyer. I don't really care. I gotta drop some shit off in my outpost here. Let's get that done right now. Put these shotguns away for later, in case I want to go skill into shotgun. But this is just, I mean, it's a framework of a game. It's fun for what it is, but it's not as good as it should be. It's not as complete as it should be. It's not as full as it should be. Everything's half-baked, half-assed, and the cracks are glaring. They're not even, you can't even say, oh, well, you're just being picky and shit. I'm all, no, dude, this is like a glaring lack, you know? Like the whole Rangers thing. I'm still salty about that. I'm not even going to pretend that I'm not. But the fact that you get to the end of the thing where you're a cop and you have to murder someone. I'm like, I have weapons that can subdue him. I don't have to kill him. I can cuff him and stop him. Like, no, you've got to kill him. Why? Well, because. Oh, okay. Sure, Jan. It's just that type of crap. It starts to get on your nerves after a while. So I got 9 of those. I've been to that one 9 times. Been to that one 8 times. Been to that one 8 times, 5 times, whatever the fuck. 9 times there. But it's just, I don't know. It's just, it's an adequate game. They got complacent. They spent more time polishing the trophies in the lobby than they did actually playing other games to see where the industry was going. Yeah? And that's why the shipbuilding is pretty much the only real thing in here that is remarkable. But even that is just, I mean, it's entertaining, sure. And a lot of people have a lot of fun with it. But it's a gigantic credit sink, yeah. So in order to get the credits, you got to go out and do stuff. And when you do stuff, you say, well, this is kind of, I don't know. But it's fun. It's just, let me put it to you this way. Let me say it like this. Normally when I get a new Bethesda game, Fallout, Skyrim, whatever, I play the fuck out of it for a long time. A long time. Do the first one where I make my just throwaway character, blast through the game, learn how it works. Then I make a second character with what I've learned. Play that for a while. If I still need to make a third character, whatever the fuck. Try out different play styles, try out different things, see how it works. Run around, explore things, do all the quests I missed the first time. Try and find the unexplored things that I found the last time, whatever the fuck. Yeah? So it'll take me. It generally takes me 6 months, 8 months, a year before I've completed my initial pass of getting into, you know, the title, right? After a while, I've seen everything, I've done everything, I get bored, and I go do something else. This usually takes a year, year and a half, 2 years, shit like that. This game, my first, I'm bored, I'm gonna go play something else moment happened on Wednesday. Took 2.5 months before I'm like, I'm just done. I've seen, there's no compelling reason to keep playing. I mean, I do, because it's interesting to explore. But even that, after a while, it's like I'm seeing the same shit over and over, you know? People go, oh, well, you just play the crap out of it. That'll happen with every game. I'm all, yes, it will happen with every game. And this will happen to every player at some point, right? It shouldn't happen this soon. And I'm gonna go do this one. Noelle, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. We're gonna do a mission. I generally don't like doing missions because I generally avoid doing the missions. I mean, I do all the faction quests, right? I did Ryuge and I'll never do it again. It's so terrible. it's sanitized. It's so sterile and so out of touch with reality. It's just like, whatever. It's hard for my brain to reconcile what I have to do in the missions versus how I know things work. You know what I mean? And I'm doing good. We're doing good. We're getting by. We're going to do a quest. But the reason I don't do the missions in this game like I normally do is because the design is so poor and the writing is so bland and so narrow and so sanitized and so unsatisfying. I know when I do this mission, I will not get any officer with the piss. I know that they won't recognize my feats. They won't recognize who I am. They won't know that I'm a fucking operative for Ryujin. They won't know I'm a Ranger. They won't know I'm a Vanguard. They won't know I'm anything. Yeah? They won't know I was a pirate. They don't know I've killed 12,000 people. It doesn't play out for 4 years. Starfield is bleh. Yeah. It's unfinished. It's half-cooked. It's not... But I'm gonna give you an example. We did the constant the last time, right? We laughed at how fucking cheesy it was. It's like, oh, let me gargle this corporate guy's balls. I'm like, no, that's really not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do something different. No, you can't do that. That would be mean. We can't allow you to be mean.
Ebside's a bad place for tourists these days. Alberia's gone to hell.
Do you say that to every random stranger that walks through the fucking door, homie? Are you lonely? Do you want to buy you a prostitute or a therapist? Shut up. So I go to Madame Savage's place. Okay, so as an adult, as someone who is aware of how the world works, you hear that advertisement, you hear this music, you're thinking, what kind of debauchery, what kind of den of iniquity is this going to be? What's it going to be? Oh my God, what kind of crazy shit's going on in here, man? What kind of sin are we going to be able to get into? And you walk in, and it's a fucking food court cafeteria. Yes, this is where the fun never stops. Nobody ever sleeps. And you're like, I walked into a Sbarro's, buddy. What the fuck is this? Maybe there's something cool upstairs. No, we've got some Fisher-Price My First Booze fucking bottles here. You walk in here. This is locked, okay. You don't look like you're having a lot of fun. And they got a bar up here with more booze, with more brightly colored my first intoxication, Fisher Price style. But it's like, really? This is the Den of Iniquity? Evil in one of their games. Yeah, you can be a petty bitch if you want to. They let you do that. You can be an asshole in a way that a seventh grader would recognize. But as for truly evil, betraying people you know, backstabbing your friends, that doesn't happen. A lot of bathrooms in here. Sanitize for your protection, yeah. It's bizarre. Also, it's bizarre that I can just walk into the back room of this fucking sleazy, skeezy bar to where it looks like the owner's bed is back here and nobody says a word. They don't go, you're not allowed back here. They don't go, what are you doing? I just gotta walk back here. I guess this is where the party is. But it's this type of shit, right? It jolts you out of the whole... Oh, and I'd like to point out that this dingy, seedy dive bar is better lit than Lynn's office at the Kazal dig site. Jet Jaguar, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. There's Grace Early. I wish I could have recruited her. She's a good ship jagger.
Yeah.
But you can't. And if you talk to her, she doesn't do nothing, right?
Velocity's such a grab, right?
Yeah, literally. Look at this. No response. She was the shipjacker in the first the Freestar Collective quest line. But now that I'm done with her, I literally cannot interact with her in any way. She doesn't even acknowledge my presence. That's some world building. Okay, what have you got? Bon Jovi tribute band, maybe?
Pardon. What are you looking at? This? This is Ebbside Striker's turf.
Only the upstairs. Don't bother my customers.
Fine, upstairs. That's gang.
Okay, that's gang, Tori. Feels like I'm in a regular bar. Got it, thanks for the warning. Trying to scare me, feeling badly. These are my options. If you're trying to scare me, you're failing badly.
Yeah, back in the day, you would never. Ugh. Yeah, you used to be people were afraid of the Strikers. We had a name, got it? Now the disciples got us penned up in this lousy bar.
Andrea.
Fine, fine, fine. This beautiful establishment.
So grow a pair. What are you talking to me about?
Anything else, or are we done with?
Okay, again, clumsy, right? It's just, can you tell me about the upside striker? So what the fuck, I look like a kiosk, dude? Get out of my face. But this is their idea of a gang in a syndicate city. This is.
So you stroll in here and want to meet with Briggs? The nerve. Maybe you should meet with the business end of my
business end of my ship, tourist, whatever.
Fine, fine already. You're lucky. Only way you
take me to him, I'll think about joining. I always wanted to be in a gang. I've always wanted to be in a gang. Because that's how gang recruitment works. I just want to hang with you guys. Can we just hang out? Let's go make some s'mores. Play spin the bottle. They're a fucking gang. Gang.
You know, I'll just do
that. I'll just do that. Sure, let's meet the boss. Yeah, you got nothing else to do. I could, now, for all this bitch knows, I could be sent by the upside strikers to kill your leader. No suspicion, no wariness, no nothing. What? Like, what? This is not how it works. No wonder the upside strikers are kicking your ass if you're this fucking stupid and weak and soft. God damn. These gangs are hard. Yeah, hard to stomach. So she unlocks the door and I go up talk to Briggs. Walk in with my gun out. They're a gang. You are all awfully fucking casual about this.
Who's this?
Someone said they might want to join.
A recruit?
I know, right? Savage says we can't go killing people around here anymore.
We shouldn't be doing that anyhow.
All four essential.
What are you doing?
This isn't worth it.
I'm at a loss for words. All four of them are essential. All four are essential. So I'm going to go out on a limb. Okay? I'm going to go out on a limb. And I'm going to say the quality of a game's writing design is inversely proportional to the number of essential NPCs that it has. The more NPCs it has that are essential, the worse the writing is. Because it's a shortcut. To make sure the player, to make sure they don't have to design for the possibility that the player might have to fucking fail a quest. But I mean, literally, I walked up in here with the gun out and shot them all in the face, and they kept talking. And I'm like, I don't. But this is why I don't do them, right? This is why I don't do the quests. Because you don't have any real options. You basically just connect the dots, paint inside the lines, follow the path, chutes and ladders style to the end of the thing, and you get your prize. Yeah? It's basically the participation trophy level of quest design.
Who's this?
Someone says they might want to join.
A recruit? Been a while.
I know, right? Savage says we can't go killing people around here anymore.
We shouldn't be doing that anyhow. You want to join us? We're a gang. You understand that, right? Not some daring adventure bullshit you can brag to your friends about.
Okay.
We steal, we mug, we kill if we have to. People that come to us have usually run out of options. So are you really interested?
Okay. We mug, we steal, we kill. Literally 10 seconds ago, he tells the chick we don't do that. What? We mug, we steal, we kill. No, you don't. No, I'm not sure I need to know first. Whatever. I really am interested in joining a gang. I really want to fucking sign up with you guys. Can we hang out? Pinky swear. What is this? It's like, I'm only here to deal with disciples. They're a menace. I'm just going to pick this. Fuck it. Because it doesn't matter. That's the thing about these stories, right? It doesn't matter which one you pick. You're going to be gently nudged on rails to the exact spot you be. It's like the little cars at Disneyland, the Autopia cars. Yeah, you've got steering and gas and brakes, but you can't really go very far off the center line because... Let's do this.
There was a time when we were the only ones that kept those psychos in line. But let me tell you about us.
Okay, now comes the expo dump. Lore dump!
We're family. It's us against every goddamn thing the world can throw at us. If you're in, we'll go through hell and back for you.
Yeah, you're a real hard ass.
Too much of that hell going round.
Vogel, not the time. We do everything we can to make sure everyone's got a roof overhead and fish in their belly. I prefer we fleece the marks, not kill them. Better for everyone in the long run. But you do what you gotta do.
Yeah, you're a hard ass. Fine, sign me
not
up.
So fast. I gotta... What would you bring to this...
No offense, but I'm smart, more confident than anyone you got.
Confident, I like it. You know your own worth.
Martin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream.
Anything special? Something that might impress us.
Well, I just killed everybody in this room in less than 4 seconds about 20 minutes ago. But you know, I need to prove to you. And of course, okay, so you tell him you're from Constellation, you have a Thermor threat, you're Vanguard, Region, blah, blah, blah. I've done all this shit, that's my bona fides. None of these choices are going to matter. They're all flavor text. Yeah, Dag, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. But again, this is the type of bland shit I'm talking about, on the kind of guardrails. In a game that had actual quality writing, choosing different options would mean different things rather than just the next line he says and then on with the show. Someone's gonna do this.
Really? I heard the Freestar Rangers did that. You know what? Never mind. I'm not sure what your game is.
There's a test.
You're going up against the disciples.
Yep, yep.
Some people snap.
Yep, they're maniacs.
The test is to find out who...
I can tell you who's a syndicate.
This is pointless.
Yeah, I'm aware it is, dude. Yeah, that's the truest thing you're going to see in the thing all day, this game all day.
We're fully in alignment there. There's a warehouse they use, one of our...
Oh, that's my job.
You want it? Too bad, Vogel. You go in. I want someone that can snatch it from me.
And see, here we go. Now we're going to do another stealth mission. When stealth is fucking broken.
Your audition.
It's so broken, they're fixing it in the patch notes.
New fish.
Trying to get killed. Dude, whatever. So now... We do a fetch quest, right? We do the talking, then we do the fetch quest. Yeah, let's do a fetch quest.
Haven't seen a leech in a while.
Now, here's the thing. He's all, preferably not killing anybody. I want to kill you. Lost Jayhawk, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. It feels like 10 years old. That's because it is, dude. That's because it is, Jayhawk. It's literally a Mass Effect mod for Fallout. That's what it is. In essence. Not too many times I crash doing this meanless, pointless quest. But this is why I don't do the quests, right? Because as soon as I see the dialogue options, I can immediately think of 5 different things I could say that I want to say that I can't. I can think of all the various options I could do to resolve the situation that you can't. In a way, it's good because you can get to the quest no matter how stupid you are. But it shouldn't be designed for the lowest common denominator. I'm just gonna go ahead and put that out there. It shouldn't be designed for the lowest common denominator. It's just so sanitized, and that makes it uninteresting. Again, like a bowl of plain oatmeal, it'll fill you up. It'll keep you healthy, keep you happy. But you won't look forward to it, you won't remember it, and there's really nothing noteworthy about it. You don't talk about it with your friends because you don't care. It's a fucking bowl of oatmeal. Like, well, I got through it. I had food. Of all the games, this is certainly one of them. Terrible launch. Maybe Starfield could fix itself. Well, Commander lost Jayhawk. That depends entirely on how much faith you have in Bethesda to take chances. As we noted before, as many people other smarter people than me have said, this game is like an empty house. It's a foundation. It's a foundation for a good game. But it didn't have anything in there. Yeah. When you think about it, modders. Again, modders, right? So you're gonna pay $70 for people to work for free. And that's gonna be quality. Not you, just, you know, in general. That's the angle they've taken. It's like, yeah, we'll just give them a nice playground to make a good game out of, and we'll wait for them to make a good game out of it. You're like, is that how it's supposed to work now? Is that how we're doing it? But like, if you look at Fallout 4 and you look at Skyrim, okay, people go, oh, well, they could totally change it up, you know, post-release. I mean, look at CP2077, look at No Man's Sky. I'm like, yeah, look at CP2077. They redesigned the entire fucking skill system, added an entirely new combat dynamic and driving dynamic. Added a whole new bunch to the game. Added an entirely new NPC, voiced NPC. Yeah? They did that, right? Hello Games? They've done, what, 29 million patches? They've literally reset their universe, right? They take chances. Okay? Bethesda does not take chances. Okay? They like the proven. They like the known. They like the safe. In order to innovate, you gotta take chances. In order to make something that's noteworthy, you gotta take chances. And they just don't. And they're not gonna start. Yeah? So with all the DLC they got coming out, it's not gonna change anything. You'll still be able to wear a UC uniform to a fucking Crimson Fleet, meaning nobody will give a shit. You can fly the Mantis into the key and nobody will care. You know. They want me to sneak, I ain't fucking sneaking, dude. I'm popping some skulls. So I want to show you something, too. Okay? Sanitizer. Let me show you this. I am currently holding a weapon that does 883 points of damage, right? I have a sneak bonus of 5 times. So if I pop this dude in the skull, it's going to do 5,000 points of damage. He's got about 60 health. Looks like I hit him with a trank dart. Yeah? And Martin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I welcomed you before. You came in earlier, right? I want to make sure Hello Games Run will continue. And ES6 is amazing. They won't. They'll release an EX6 that's basically ES5 with prettier graphics. And that's it. It'll be the same game. They don't take chances, Jayhawk. They don't take chances. That said, as an old, there is a certain comfort in the familiar. I don't have to think too much to play this game. I don't have to try too hard to play this game. I don't have to worry about dying too much in this game. It's not that difficult. Yeah. It's just not that interesting. Yeah. We got these gangs. Oh, there's gangs. Oh my god, the gangs are blah. Whatever, dude. We're going to take the slate out of the marked box here. Take that. Take the lubricant, because why not? And we're going to leave. We're a ghost, right? We just murdered 3 people. Nobody gives a fucking shit. Nobody cares. You don't feel familiar with New Bethesda. Well, you are familiar with New Bethesda. It's the same as old Bethesda. They haven't changed, yeah? We can look in here. What's in here? Oh, look. There's stuff in here. Probably nothing I need. Just storage, right? Vanadium, yeah. Chlorosalines. Water. But yeah, here's this big gang. Oh, it's this big gang. Fucking whatever, dude. It's a goddamn warehouse. It's like there's nothing in here. But you'll notice, right? I shot these two dudes for about 4,000 points of damage. They are perfectly intact. No bullet holes. One tiny little spot of blood. They could just be sleeping. Other than bruised rib. Yikes, man. I hope you heal fast. Hope it heals up good. So let's go in. Let's go back to the dude. We walk into the warehouse, shoot three people. Why am I playing this then? To show y'all what this game is. Yeah. So y'all can make informed decisions. And I play this game, Jayhawk, because I like the exploration. Okay, I like the exploration. I enjoy exploring. I could wish there were more to find. I could wish it were more interesting. But at the end of the day, for me, it's relaxing to just sit down, have a drink, go to a new planet, wander around and look at shit. That's pretty much what I do. And I like that. I enjoy that activity. The problem with that is it's boring as fuck to watch on the stream because I don't talk much. I just kind of look at things, you know, and I am entertained by that. I built my entire character to do that. Okay. And I do it a lot. I play it a lot. I don't generally do, I don't go back to towns. I don't do missions. Yeah. But I just wanted to show, basically, I want to go through the game. So if anybody watches this later, they can see So I was going to do this. So for exploration, I have landed on 391 planets, fully scanned 214 flora, fully surveyed 570 planets, scanned 1500, right? So I'm going on my 400th planet that I've walked around on. I like that. It's fun. But it's boring. It's boring to watch. Yeah. You're playing Phantom on 77. So much better. Yeah, there's a lot of comparisons that No Man's is still more interesting. I'm going to agree to disagree on that one. A little bit. But then I say that because I've explored so much No Man's Sky that I can knock out an entire planet in like 20 minutes. I don't even have to think about it anymore. I don't have to work very hard at it. And because I've done it so much, I haven't done nearly as much in this game. Okay, now we go to Madame Savage's, find out where the... Once we go back this way? But No Man's Sky is both more and less interesting. Okay. I'm actually going to agree with... Okay. Let me just jetpack over you since you can't figure out how to walk around. Got bias, you have so many hours. Well, everybody's got bias, man. Everybody's got bias. There's, you know, whatever. But from a feature standpoint, No Man's Sky is both more and less interesting than this. Because I'm going to go out and tell you straight up that empty plans are actually a good thing. It gives you a little bit of variety. No Man's Sky, it's just full of life everywhere. It gets boring after a while.
Do what it takes to survive.
And, you know, having multiple biomes on a planet is very, very cool. Other than, you know, having to fast travel between them. You can't fly between them. But 6 1/2 dozen of another. Yeah? Let's listen to what this guy has to say. I'd prefer he didn't kill anybody.
If the disciples spot you, they're going to attack straight away.
So I had to take out some disciples. I had to take out some disciples to do it. Whatever.
So stealth was a no-go, but... Shit. You took all of them out. The strikers can use that.
Yeah, I know
so
they can.
So you're in. Everyone thinks the Ebsite.
So yeah, I'm in. I'm a gang member now.
Now that we know where the disciples
are. I bet his eyes bug out.
I feel the tide is turning.
Yeah, they probably will. It's mostly the ones that aren't talking. I thought you were in dire straits, really? IGHT, huh, guys? Yeah. Yeah. I
trying to score points with the boss. Smart play, new fish.
Dude, I can murder you all where
you
stand. Shut up.
Say hello to the rest of the gang.
Whatever.
After you take some deserved R&R, hit a pet.
Okay, now I got Striker Maskwear. Cool. So I got a new item. I got 50 XP. XP doesn't scale with level. Right. Which means these are like newbie entry level quests, side quests. So they're going to give you 50 here, 75 here, 100 there. Motherfucker, I need 16,000 to get to the next level. I can get 400 XP for killing I can kill an alien critter on a fucking planet. Okay. There's literally no XP reward for this. So it's like, what do you got?
Neon's a living thing.
Whatever.
And it feasts on our pain. Huh. So you survived.
Whatever. She could join the long line of people wishing me harm.
We are more alike than I thought.
No, we're nothing alike.
Everyone is hard because they have to be.
You're hard?
The streets and alleys are all on
you out. Call this hard?
They chew up the weak. They leave them broken or dead in the gutters. So don't be weak.
This is gonna make me break out into a musical. I'm waiting for the fucking knife fight, dude, with the soundtrack. Yeah. What has Bethesda been doing with Microsoft money? What they've been doing is polishing the game mechanically, Jayhawk. Because the one thing I can say with some confidence that's actually a compliment, this title is the most stable, most error-free, most jank-free thing they've ever published. Period. Okay? The fact that it still crashes and has save file issues and broken quests up, it's still the best they've ever done. Okay, so what they're not doing is taking chances. Yeah.
Whenever you are ready, I
yeah, good pep
you.
Talk there.
You are funny. Funny won't keep you alive.
Yeah, I know, guns do, dude.
So the job is, we let the street...
Yeah, yeah.
Hacking the signs is easy. Getting to them or fighting in a... Briggs said he prefers no...
Yeah, whatever. Oh, there will be blood.
Good. If you need things too, I can hook you up.
Good
luck.
Hook me up. Can we get to the hook me up part of the thing?
A lot of the signs are high up. Of course.
A lot of signs are high up. Bitch, I jump off 600 meter mountains for fun. What have you got? Weapons? You got anything good? Advanced, sure. No legendaries. Cyberware, flashy, jacketed, leatherware, Neo City Hustler, nothing. Okay, throwables, I don't care. Because it's bugged. Crap in there. Resources, chasm mass oil, and a digipick. You got nothing. You're a shitty vendor.
Be careful. Be smart out there.
Oh, well, sorry. No, it's... You want this game to be better. So do I. I want it to make me go, wow, that was fucking cool. Which I have done 3 times so far. Exactly 3 times. And I can remember where they were. One was during the UC quest, when we saw the heat leech in the little cage. That was one. I was like, holy fucking shit, that was cool. The second time was the Entangled quest, which is near the end of the main quest line. Holy shit, that was cool. Also derivative. The third time was the first time I went to an abandoned mining platform, and I got jumped by those fucking swarming things. That was fucking cool. I did not expect that. And the fact that I did not expect to be surprised was surprising. Yeah, it was its own editorial. The amount of development. Yeah, I don't. The problem is, the biggest problem, dude. Like I said, they don't take chances. Right? The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. And the fact that they've got an engine so old, there's probably dinosaur bones in the code. It's just. It's like, do they not play other games? I guess is the question. Because there's, as time goes by and as games are released, developers stand on the shoulders of developers, right? They see a thing in a game and they're like, this is fucking cool. I want to make my own version of this. So they make their own version of it, and it's cooler. It's more improved. It's interesting. It's different. It advances the games industry. It puts the genre out, right? This game does none of that. There's literally nothing in this game that hasn't been done somewhere else and better. I don't understand what... How much G we got here?
I just don't think we'll
147?
I barely survived.
That's too high. We got some red dots, but I don't really give a fuck about a little bit of murder. So I'm supposed to go here. Let's go here. Where does this take me? Underbelly? Let's go there. It looks like 5 years old. Yeah, it's just, there's no advancement here. It's like they've learned nothing. Yeah. They've been living in a bubble, right? Smelling their own farts, I guess. spending a lot of time making sure all the trophies in the lobby are nice and gleaming from being polished. But it's not... Okay. Their version of hacking the sign is pushing a button. No minigame.
What have we here? There's a steep.
How about you fuck off?
You pay the fine now.
Pay the fine now. There's no way I'm paying you, homie.
Wrong answer.
Yeah? Yeah? You want it? 15,000 bounty. Okay, cool. So at 15,000 ahead. So we're gonna I'm not gonna quick save it. We're gonna ride this out. I'm gonna ride this out. Wow, you got a bolstering navigator spacesuit on you? I mean, it's a piece of shit. But holy crap, you dropped a rare. So now we get to kill some neon security. Where are they at? Also, you'll note they're shooting right through civilians. Just wanna point that out. I just pistol whip your ass, dude. What? Who are you? Cosmos Bacchus? What is this? A named guy? In his underwear because we can't be bothered to put clothes on our NPCs. Alright. You know, at this point, oh wait, neon security uniform? Oh, I'm taking that. Okay, we good? Cool. Neon security helmet, look at that. Okay. Oh, so Dakita, if you're still watching, this is being evil. Murdering a bunch of level 12 guys. Okay. Where you at? You up here? Where are they? They're not down there. Oh, there he is. Da 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 da. 15,000 bounty. I don't even care, dude. Do you know how much fucking money I have? You know what? I am gonna reload it. I don't wanna deal with this. I just don't wanna deal with it. I'm gonna load this game here. It used to be the kings and other jokes. Well, they haven't learned anything. They don't advance. They don't play other games. And they don't take chances. Yeah. Yeah, killing the corrupt neon security is get you a bounty. But if you're rich enough like I am, I'm like, whatever, I can just pay it off. But I just want to deal with it. I just don't even want to deal with it. I'm like, fuck it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to be stunned. Now that I know that a trip in that switch is going to make me wanted. Sure. And of course, you got to love the fact that one thing I do want to point out too. This has been a symptom from all their other games. I murder a guard. Instantly, every single guard anywhere in the fucking city is on high alert. Immediately. Are they all psychic? Have it take a little time for the word to get out. Yeah. Nah, we're just gonna make everything aggro all the time. Same with the bounty in the missions. It's probably bugged though. Okay, so now I know. Right? I know that tripping the switch is going to make the guy come over. Short. So now we're going to do is we're going to be hidden. Yeah? Completely hidden. Now we're going to move away. Right? Now, here's the question. Will the guard have seen me? Will the guard have seen me and will come up to arrest me? This is what I fucking mean. This is the guardrail bullshit. This is the fucking sanitized railroading. You can't get away from this. You can't outthink. We don't have the capability to allow you to make any real decisions.
Zero tolerance.
Tell you what, you pay the fine.
And we're back here. If I walk up and trip the switch, I get this shit. If I sneak up to where I'm purposely 100% hidden, and then I'm hidden as I walk away from the switch, I get this. If I wear a clown suit and put sparklers and fireworks up, I get this. Yeah? This is what I mean about sanitize on guardrails, railroading you into shit. Persuade.
Maybe.
You're gonna blow my cover.
Yeah.
Nobody called me.
Yeah, whatever. You better make a decision, I'll make it for you.
I'm ready when...
I'm done talking.
Okay, so now we just reload. Safe scum. Yeah? That's what we do here. This is fun. But yeah, Jet, in this game you don't have options. You have... it's a role-playing game. Yeah, it's role-playing in the sense that if you're lawful good, chaotic good, or neutral good, you can role-play. But if you have any kind of creative thought, if you've got any kind of problem-solving skills, if you have any sort of alternate way of solving problems, it doesn't fucking matter. Just get drunk, shut your brain off, get a prefrontal lobotomy, and look at the pretty colors. I guess. This is why I don't do the missions, yeah? Because it's like, it's this type of shit. Are there moments where you have characters that are dying of something that's meaningful? Yeah, but it's all scripted. So it's not meaningful in any way. I mean, it's meaningful in that if you actually get attached to them, sure. But it's like, oh, it's such a big plot twist. It's a plot twist, really. Jayhawk, can I ask you a question? Did you play Mass Effect 1, the first Mass Effect? I'm guessing that maybe you did. You seem to play a lot of games. I'm gonna give you an example I'm talking about. You played Mass Effect 1, right? The first one? If you did, do you remember Vermeier? Okay, do you remember Vermeier, Ashley and Caden? And, I forgot his fucking name. He's going to blow up the dam or release the genophage or whatever the fuck it is. He's gonna do the thing. You remember that? Okay. You remember the choice you had to make at Vermeier? And what happened there? Yeah. That's this game's idea of cutting-edge storytelling. They did the exact same thing. People go, oh my god, I never saw this coming. I'm all, do you not play video games? I'm just asking. Because it's ripped straight from Vermeier, the decision to choose. Yeah. This is that moment in this game. To the point where, when it happened, right, when I was going through the main quest and that mission came up, and I said, you have a choice, I'm like, it's fucking Vermeier. Somebody's going to die. It was no shock, no surprise, no nothing. And, yeah, that's their cutting-edge, emerging gameplay storytelling. I'm just like, are you fucking kidding me? So, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this time. We're going to talk our way through this. 25 persuasion, I'll put the business suit on. And now we're gonna do it. Let's do this. Let's get past this shit. Ashley always wins. Sometimes I keep Caden around because his emo sad sack bullshit. Here he comes, right? Scripted! Come on, buddy. Come on over. Come on.
What have we here?
Yeah.
There's a steep.
Yeah, whatever, dude.
Tell you what.
How the fuck did you see me, dude? Psychic on me?
Maybe.
This isn't what you want. You had other options.
Maybe I did.
Yeah. Don't think you're walking away from this.
I never said I was done talking. Fine, fine.
Yeah, so there you go. Quick save scum. I'm done. La-dee-dee. So now let's go to the other two. It wants me to go to the elevator. Let's go to the elevator. But that's what we're talking about here. That's this game's big twist, and it's hallmark quality storytelling. That was its twist. Although it could be argued that the UC Vanguard quest actually had an interesting subplot. And in fact, if they'd have made that the main quest, I don't think a lot of people would complain. I don't think that a lot of people would have complained. Okay, so I gotta go up. Is there a stairway around here? Can we get up there somehow? And of course, unlike 76, you can't walk through NPCs because reasons. Bring it up on this one, right? Okay. Physics. LOL. Okay. Wait for it to recharge, go up this way. No, it's not gonna be high enough. Okay. Alright, is there somewhere else I can jump up on? No. Maybe over here? Fuck! God damn it! Alright, let's try it again.
That's wild! How did it go?
It was pretty fun.
But yeah, it's just, it's... It has its moments. But the reason it has those moments is because the rest of the moments are so awful. Okay, so they're down over here, right? Oh, there's a stairway right there. And they're up over there. Can I go this way?
What?
What? Who's aggroing? You up here?
They'll never find your body.
Shit. There. And yeah, that's AI. Mm-hmm. Where did that body go? Oh. Twenty-5 years. You really want to Starfield? Me too. Well, I wanted it to be good, but what I really wanted it after playing it, what I really want is for it to be better than it is. It should not just be a fucking reskin of Fallout 4, okay? With most of the interesting parts missing. And yet, here we are. But I enjoy the exploration. Yeah, I do enjoy the exploration. It's just not a compelling thing to stream, right? Because I go, look, he found it. Look, oh my god, he found another animal. That's like, woo! He was like, where are we going? Here? Okay. Don't know if there's anybody up here. So yeah, their idea of gang warfare is changing some fucking signs. Hmm. Yeah, okay. Sanitization, ho! Okay. Planets and space battles. Yeah, I wanted to explore stuff too. There is exploration in the game, and it is vaguely rewarding. And Marty, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Hopefully the modding community will make it better. Well, they certainly can't make it worse. I'm just waiting for the one that flips the essential flags to off on every NPC. Because here's the thing about this game, right? And why it doesn't even adhere to its own thing. Think about this for a minute, okay? In Morrowind, you could kill NPCs. It would warn you, hey, you're going to fuck up your game and close off quest lines if you do this, right? Okay, that's fair. You have consequences for your actions. This game doesn't have any consequences for your actions, right? But here's the thing. I'm going to wave at the screen as I do this. The main quest line of the game, its entire reason for existence, is because the player can travel between universes. This means there is even less reason to make NPCs essential. Because you can just go through the Unity and try it again. You have to reload an earlier save. You've got an entirely new fucking universe to do it in. But yet there are more essential NPCs in this game than in any game I have ever seen in my life. They are everywhere. Okay, so I've got the fitted suit on. Let's put the fitted suit back on in case someone wants to yell at me again. Let's take the paramour. Oh no, what am I doing? I've got it on the hotkeys. Let's just do this. Go here. We're hidden. 100% hidden, man. Nothing flickering on the bar, nothing moving. and none of the guards move. Because I guess these guys aren't psychic. Literally.
Straight to lockup.
Walk up to an NPC, take your gun out, put the muzzle right in his fucking mouth, and he's like, oh, I'm just gonna stand here and make empty threats. Good. Good. Empty planets need a loading screen. Because the proc gen's gotta generate them, dude. I know the answer. That one there, I actually know the answer to. Because his engine is 25 years old, and it cannot handle the player moving more than about 25-30 miles an hour. Anything that moves more than about 30 miles an hour, this game literally will crash trying to render it, because this engine is so archaic. Okay, that's why you can't fly over planets, because the planets are proc gen. So the game has to generate the planets as you fly over them. So if you wanted to do that, you could do that. They could actually make it possible for you to fly over a planet. It would be very, very simple. You would simply be going 12 miles an hour, and that'll make it very, very fun for people. Yeah. So what happens when you land, right, is it's generating the play tile, right? It's generating the terrain. It's deciding which POIs to put down. It's deciding what animals to put in there. It's remembering what biome it is. There's a lot of shit going on there. I get that. That's not a problem. Okay. But the fact that it's so many loading screens in the cities is just, again, when you're building your code out of dinosaur bones, man, it's going to be a little bit rickety. Yeah.
I think you're going to fit in well. Really well.
Yeah, I need your personal approval, dude. I don't give a fuck. I want that jacket.
You really kicked the hornet's nest. Andrea's running point on grabbing the gun stash.
So we're finally doing this?
It's time, Vogel. Both of you, keep the collateral damage.
Whatever. I'll do what it takes to win. Thank you.
Like the attitude, but don't give Neon security.
Shut up, dude. You two, those are your problems, not mine.
I know this is asking a lot. Newell's goods has some armor. Not mil-spec ranger gear or anything, but better. So if you could, well, spring for some armor upgrades, maybe convince Newell to sell it to us.
Well, happy birthday to your mom, Marty. Thanks for stopping in. Tell her hi for me. You're right. That's asking for a hell of a lot. That's not happening. I'm not going to fucking buy you shit, dude. What are you even talking about? He's all, yeah, you've been a gang member. You killed six people. You're just a hard ass. Now I need you to spend out of pocket to buy me some fucking armor. That's not happening.
Well, I had to ask.
Yeah, you can ask.
We'll manage.
Yeah, I don't care, dude. Again, 75 XP. I got more XP from killing the dudes.
Maybe you'd like to try a velocity.
Aren't you supposed to be tending bar downstairs? So you tell him to fuck off, right? You tell him, I'm not going to do it for you. So what's the optional say? Get armor for the strikers. There is nothing quite like telling the player to their face, your choices just don't fucking matter. What you want doesn't make any difference. You're going to do it this way. This is the way you're supposed to do it. This is why you're going to do it. You know what? I'm curious. I'm going to go down and see Newell. Fuck it. We're going to go down and see Newell. I just don't care. Sure, I'll wipe this guy's ass. What the fuck, right? That's what you do in a gang, right? You buy presents for everybody when you join. What? My first gang warfare by Fisher Price. Christ almighty. Let's go through two more loading screens to get back up to the top. Load and load and load and load and load and load. Why there are loading screens for elevators? My guess, Martin, is because this game has a lot of high-res textures, man. And you need to load those things, man. You can't stream them. The loading screens are amazing. I'm glad you like them, Jayhawk. There's lots of them. And now let's go ahead and talk to the vendors like it's medieval France. Like you can't just go to a kiosk and just buy what you want out of it, right?
Dietrich's been great at the meet.
And of course all the shit on here on the back deck is not for sale. You can't buy it.
Just want to say again, I'm grateful.
Okay, let's do this. Fuck it.
Oh dear. Did Briggs put you up to this? All these gangs are a menace. I don't want to have any part of it.
This is... He speaks about a fucking gang leader like he's a wayward 8-year-old. Oh, is Briggs at it again? Did he say it was okay with Mom for you to get the armor? He's a fucking gang leader. But I guess in this town, this is what it is. Facts that Briggs hasn't forced the issue has to be worth something. Why won't you sell to them? Tell me your lies. I do like this guy's voice, though. Listen to this guy's voice.
Because they're bottom-feeding parasites. They steal and murder, and security couldn't care less.
Yeah.
Us businessmen have to draw a line somewhere, and this is...
Us businessmen have to draw a line somewhere. It's we. Learn to write. My. Go back to eighth grade and learn your grammar rules. It's we businessmen, not us businessmen. Whatever.
I've known Briggs for ages, and he's there dangerous.
Okay, the gang leader. You're telling him Briggs doesn't force the issue.
I've known Briggs for ages, and he's not the problem. It's people like Hatchet and Andrea. They're dangerous.
So he basically says the leader of the gang isn't dangerous. He just said the leader of the gang isn't dangerous.
They are definitely the lesser evil.
Oh, God. Noel, welcome back.
All right, already. You pay and I'll send Briggs his... I don't want anything to do with it.
Given the circumstance, any chance of a discount?
That's not a discount.
Who knows how long before you get it?
In my experience... I get the feeling you're...
Now it gives me manipulation on the third one. Yeah? You need to give me on the first one.
You're starting to... Fine. I'll get the armor over to me.
Now, I want to point something out here.
Now, James, I don't want you to...
None of the speech options...
But Administrator
Baker, let me use the fact that I got Dietrich...
Oh, yeah?
They got Sieghart.
He decided to come down from his throne and walk amongst us peasants.
Earlier in the game, he has a problem with Sieghart. Sieghart's paying Neon security and it's bad for them. He's trying to make a Merchants Alliance. So I basically talk Sieghart into joining the Merchants Alliance, and he's super fucking happy about this. Oh my god, the merchants have an alliance and shit like that, blah, 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 blah. Right? Newell has completely forgotten about the fucking favor I did him. I can't lean on something I've already done with this guy to convince him. If the writing is lazy, why just put the grammar be correct? I don't. I'm just pointing out. It's just another signpost. Croucho, I guess, is what you could say. It's another signpost. But it's exactly that type of shit where I'm like, you're a professional paid to write and you don't know 8th grade grammar? Let's just get this over with. That's what it is, Groucho. It's not surprise. It's more like, see? Yeah? If that makes any sense at all. And like the Dire Straits. Straits spelled Straights. Really? You don't even know... At least I made it past the spell checker, so I guess that's something. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a... I need to stretch, because I'm getting tense from this shit. I can't take this stuff anymore, man. Okay, so we're going to sit down here. Again, press, not... It's not... It's just click to sit, not press to sit. Press and hold, like in 76. Okay, so we're going to put her here. We're going to leave her in the gang's headquarters. I'm gonna go stretch, man, because I'm tense as fuck. So 3 to 5 minutes, folks. Refill your drinks and snacks. Smoke me if you got them. Stretch like I'm gonna, and I will be right back. And we are back. And thank you, Groucho. Let me see here. Not gonna lie, I'm interesting, but this game is not. It's just, I just don't understand Lost Jayhawk, really. That's where my biggest, I guess, problem lies with this particular title. Is I don't understand how a game company that could make things like Fallout 3 and Morrowind and Oblivion went from that to this. I don't understand how. I mean, did they focus test this group on fourth graders? I don't understand how you could have a quote unquote role playing game that didn't actually allow you to play any role other than this, you know? It's like you don't have any real options. There's no real twistiness to it. It's all very straightforward. It's all very above board. It's all very scripted. Well, it's all scripted. It has to be scripted. That's not a negative thing per se. But it doesn't allow the player any agency at all. You don't have a choice. Any real choice. Like they were making fun of you. Like, yes. Hesitant, yes. Sarcastic, yes. No, but yes. That's why it feels like it's on rails, because you don't have any other options. You can't break. There's no way to be creative in solving the problem. Like with Cyberpunk, yeah? Let's compare to Cyberpunk, Jayhawk. Let's go ahead and do that for the audience. In Cyberpunk, you are given objective and you are given tools and you say, get the job done. If you want to go in shooting, go ahead and do that. You want to just blow everybody's brains out with cyber? You can do that. You want to make them fight each other? You can do that. You want to assassinate them through the cameras? You can do that. You want to sneak around, jump into the skylight, get in and out, nobody ever seeing you, and do a pass? You can do that. You were provided tools and a problem to solve, and you were told to solve the problem. And the game accommodates a wide variety of problem-solving dynamics. This game says, here's the problem. Here's what you need to solve it. Do it. And you're just like, that's not fun.
Dreaming of this.
You've been dreaming of this. Whatever.
I'll be telling him to let his best man loose.
Whatever. They deserve it. Let's kill him.
You better believe. The plan's simple. We hit the street runners. Then Andrea can waltz it.
Right. Let's get this over with then.
Well, it'll work.
I know it will,
it's
dude.
It's three groups of street rats for you.
So now we go kill the three street rats. Okay. What if I want to work for the disciples? What if I wanted to eliminate you guys for them? Can I betray these people? Can I go talk to a disciple? No, I can't. Why? Because they're going to be hostile as soon as they see me, because that's what the game tells you how to do. There's no subterfuge. There's no subtlety. There's no interesting. It's just go here, do this, come back. Go here, do this, come back. Go here, do that, come back. Now, in earlier games, exactly. That's what I'm talking about, Jayhawk. This is the type of shit that just drives me crazy why I don't do these missions. Because I know I'm not going to be given any agency. I'm not going to be required to think. I'm not going to have to do anything other than just follow the check marks and check things off my to-do list and murder people. Like, okay, well, I don't even mind murdering people. I'm actually okay with that. But here I pull a gun out, go into crouch mode, right in front of a guard. Oh, elevator? Okay, let's go here. Yeah, you have agency, right? You have the ability to solve the problem the way that you want based on your character build and your preferences and whatever. This game is like, okay, go in, we tell you to sneak, you must sneak. If you don't sneak, we're going to yell at you. Go in here and kill these people. If you try and sneak, we're going to kill you. Go ahead and do this, we're going to yell at you. Go ahead and do this, we're going to yell at you. It's like a nagging mother-in-law. You're just like, the fuck. So let's go here to this one. Running in the middle of the street with a gun drawn. Nobody seems to give a shit. I'm like, all right, go. I don't know. That's why when they say, oh, Shattered Sun's going to be awesome. Their first DLC, right? They're working on their first DLC. Apparently you can pre-order and people already paid for it and shit. And you're like, okay, cool. Their first DLC. Look, it took so long to load, the elevator doors closed on me. People go, are you going to get Shattered Sun? I'm like, no, I have no interest in it. Hey, disciples. Wait, can I talk to them?
Looky here.
Just strolling into Disciple Turf.
I've been strolling on your turf all day.
You're making this too easy.
Okay, so my options are make them go away or kill them. No option to, hey man, Briggs, trust me. I can walk into his fucking office anytime I want to. You want to get rid of Briggs? You want to get rid of the Strikers once and for all? Let's talk. Where's that option?
No funny business.
Yep. Ooh, Disciple Streetwear, nice. Give me a mask too. Can I get that? And no guards, no cops. People running around screaming. Nothing happens. No alarms. Nothing. Just walk up, murder three people, and walk away. I want this game to be good. So did I. I want it to be better. I mean, it's good enough. It's adequate. It's something to pass the time. But there's going to be a point where I'm definitely going to... Okay. No, okay.
So you're the Strikers, darling. Yeah, we had those blighters all tied up until you came along. The name's Holt, and I'm here to offer you a deal.
Here we go. Say your piece.
Good. You're reasonable.
No, I'm not.
The Strikers are old news. Positively animal.
Here, look at this. They actually did it. I couldn't do it, but if they offer it to me, I can.
Credits, yeah? I don't.
You use credits, but you get... I won't take your blood money. Fucking whatever. I've been murdering people left, right, and center. Goody, goody, two-shoes. Snarky, stupid, and this. Why the indiscriminate violence? Who cares? It doesn't... So, do we want to betray him or not? I don't know. Do I even care? I can use credits. You can keep the dumpster.
You do the deed. We, just so you know, the other disciples will be gunning to make your way to survive.
Oh, so I don't have the option here? Didn't you have to reload, homies? Barely took any damage. Okay. So now the betray option's gone. That's the extent of their betrayal mechanic. I can't change my mind. I can't kill the disciples and then betray them anyway. No, you can't do that. You must do it the way we tell you to do it. The faces in general. I can't look at the NPCs. I when they talk, I read the subtitles, Jayhawk. I can't look at their faces. Watching them talk unnerves me to a disturbing degree. I can't look at the rubbery animatronic, lifeless eyes, rubbery faces. I can hear the gears whirring in the hall. The president's looking NPCs. It's uncanny valley in spades is what it is, right? I literally can't look at the NPCs. I haven't looked at an NPC the entire game. Well, I did it first until I started getting kind of nauseated every time I did. And I'm aware that's a personal thing, and I'm okay with that. I'm absolutely okay with that. But I can't watch them talk. I can't watch them talk. It's just, they creep me out, man. They really creep me out. The lifeless eyes is really what does it, mostly. But the way their jaws and mouth aren't synced with, because I'm hard of hearing, right? So I look at lips a lot to understand what people are saying. Yeah. I can't look at these guys. I just tried to quick save. We gonna crash? Yeah, we just crashed. It just locked up. Because they have this animation for their UI. Right? There's that intro screen for the UI, and it's animated. And it crashes the game fairly routinely. Yeah. So that's where we're at. 25 years of working on this engine, they still can't keep from crashing more than once every 20 hours. So when people tell me, hey, how many hours does it take to get through the, how many hours does it take to get to the main mission? I'm all, 4 crashes. They're like, what? 4 crashes. You won't go 20 hours without a crash. Normally it's around 12 to 15. So I just take, if it's a 60-hour quest, it'll take you about 4 crashes to get through. Yeah. This is their best effort, folks. This is their best effort. Yeah. But no, they don't need a new engine. Creation Engine 2 will get to the next generation. Yeah, sure it will. If it's 2008. So now we wait for the loading screen. You might as well go ahead and get a drink, make a snack. It's going to take about a minute and a half on an NVMe SSD to load the game. They seem like Disney. Yeah, they didn't used to be, but they are now. Elder Scrolls is screwed. I don't really care. I've gotten to the point now where I don't care when Elder Scrolls 6 comes out. Because the only thing I'll tell you straight up, Jayhawk, if they say Elder Scrolls 6 is coming out and they say they're using the Creation Engine, I'm not going to play it. I'm literally not going to play it. I'm not going to stream it. I'm not going to promote it. I won't even play it if it's on Game Pass. Okay? It's been 25 years. If your engine was a kid, it'd have a master's degree by now. I can't take it anymore. This is the last. This is just the last straw. I will play the fuck out of this game for sure. No intention of getting Shattered Sun because it's going to have the same janky writing as this one does. It's going to have the same sanitized universe. It's going to have the same lack of consequences, the same lack of agency, the same lack of options. Upgrade your shit. Yeah, it's time. It's past time. This game shouldn't have been released on this engine. I just don't care. But again, Bethesda Game Studios, more of the same, because we know it sells. And it does. This is the most successful launch ever, man. They made boatloads of money off this shit. So what's their incentive to change? None. What's the odds they're gonna change? None. But the exploration is fun. As long as I'm not exposed too long to their writing and their design, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, I like doing the little mini missions. A lot of it doesn't make any sense either, but whatever, it's fine. I can just get in my ship and go back out. Just get out there. Yeah. Okay, so now we're back here. Let's try this again. This time I'm not even gonna talk to him. I'm just gonna shoot them all because I know what's gonna happen. Yeah, just shoot them all. Fuck, I don't even care. And now there's gonna be cops at the end. I know. We're gonna see if it lets us quick save. Yeah. 2015. I would say 2012 myself, but yeah. I'm agreeing with you. I mean, it is upgraded. The textures are much higher quality. Some of the shit's really kind of cool. And but yeah, the lack of dismemberment, the lack of bullet holes. I mean, there's blood everywhere and these bodies are fully intact. And I'm just like, okay. It's a game made by dads for their kids. Yeah. Yeah, honey. You graduated from sixth grade. We made a video game for you. Okay. I don't know, man. I don't know what happened or where they lost their edge. But they have become complacent. The combat is smooth. I will grant them that. This guy just got caught on fire being too close to me. Okay. Where'd you go over here? Disciple Street, where I want that. But it is fun in a mindless, time-killing, mobile game sort of way. Doesn't have a lot of depth, doesn't have a lot of consequence, doesn't have a lot of, you know. You won't sit and think about it when you're not playing it. Unlike most of their other titles, which are like, I was constantly thinking about shit I wanted to do in Fallout 4 and in Skyrim. This game, I'm like, I just want to get this over with. Okay, so here we go again. We're going to try and quick save. Can we do it? Ah, let us do it. How about that? Okay. They go over here, and the guard's gonna be all, you killed a bunch of people. You're right, I did. Wait, who are you guys? Oh, no, you're the guys. They're the strikers. In the armor that I bought them.
We got the guns, new fish. Went in, Papa.
And that's thanks to me and my new best.
Had any problems with your best? I'm not sure about best mates. Who the fuck?
comrades in arms, then?
Whatever, dude.
Everything's going according.
Good. Now we hit them where it hurts. Not going to lie. Taking it is going to be hard. What's the play?
Stay out here and make sure I don't get interrupted.
You'll be drawing a lot of heat, but if you think...
You heard the plan.
Dude, I just murdered 20 fucking people, and I don't even have a scratch on me. But maybe don't listen to me? Defeat the disciples. Yeah, no problem. They're going to be level 6 and level 14. They don't scale to my level, so I can just go and beat them to death with a fucking baguette, dude. All right. I'm going to have fun in here. New area to explore. Where am I going? There's no dot. Okay, so now I can just do this at my own pace. You know what? Fuck it. I'm going to go in standing up. I don't even care, dude. These guys literally are a joke, dude. Literally a joke. And look at that. Level 6 weapon, dude. Why don't quests scale, dude? Why don't they scale? If this thing scaled, it would actually be challenging. Yeah. I mean, these guys are level 6, dude. I've got a DR of like 540. They have, and they're wielding Krakens, dude. They're literally not going to be able to hurt me. So, this is the door out, right? Okay. Let's go explore New Area. Again, though, I will say it before. I've said it before, I'll say it again. I will continue to say it. They're level design people. They're artists. Best in the business, man. Best in the business. I literally could spend hours just wandering around the bigger installations just looking at stuff. Because it's so fucking cool. Big mistake. Whatever, dude. I mean, just stand there. Let them punch me. Who cares? Can't even hurt me. Because they're not scaled. If they were my level, plus or minus 3, that would certainly be a lot more interesting. Okay, where are you at? Are you downstairs? Are you above me? No, you're not here. Okay, so you gotta be upstairs. Oh, no, there you are.
Easy find.
And they talk shit. I'm just like, walk up, pull the trigger. All right.
My time is over. Downstairs, now.
What? That was it? We invaded their warehouse and that was the entire... This was the big fight? You would love Night City. Yeah, no, I played the shit out of Cyberpunk. I haven't played since 2.0, though. I've been thinking about dusting it off again. But it took me a long time to learn how to play that game, man. A long time to get my, my bearings in it. So I've been hesitant to get to load the 2.0 patch because they changed all the skills, right? But no, I do love Night City, dude. I played the shit out of Cyberpunk. Look at this. So here I am. My gun is out. I just murdered like 9 people. Security somehow came in when I wasn't looking. And it's so much better now. Yeah, I saw some of the stuff that it had and it was pretty cool. But I'm like, I wanted to play this out first. I like exploration. So now we come in here. All these guards are like, hey, Hadrian, how's it going? What's up, Heller? Oh, no, these are the. I mean. Walk up with a gun in your face. Point it right at you. I bet you're essential, though. And this guy's standing in parade dress like he got recruited in the UC Navy. Okay, we're probably going to talk our way out of this. Let's go ahead and put our fitted suit on. Take our paramour. Now stand here in a reagent suit. Gun out!
You think Neon Security wouldn't know about what's going down? Please. Looks like you've done a bit of violence. A bit of murder. Word is, all this is due to you. Why are you messing around with my streets, huh?
Someone had to do some of the disciples. I was doing your job, you're welcome. I don't want any trouble. Where is the option go? I don't give a fuck about you. I'm doing this for the money. Doing your job, you're welcome. Snarky.
You would know the first thing about my job.
Yeah, whatever.
So here's what's going to happen. Gang violence gets too noisy. That hurts the bottom line around here. No one affects the
bottom line. Affects the bottom line. Tell EFF. Really?
No.
Affects the bottom line. Mr. Briggs.
The disciples have been pissing me off for far too long.
I'm just a badass.
So, your gang throws off sewer rat blue and starts wearing neon security black. Or you can be found face down in the streets. And you say your goodbyes. Briggs is a smart lad. He'll make the right choice.
What are you even... You hire him after all they've done?
The best way to fight gang violence.
Right.
Trust me.
But you put him on the force. Even you couldn't stop the gangs. That doesn't even make any sense. That's not how this works. That's not how any of this works. So I've gone in here, killed all the fucking rival gang, and now he wants to take this other gang and make them cops. Or security forces. I'm struggling to think of a way that I want out of all this.
That works for me too. Don't take too long. Time to
onboard the new hires. Did anyone watching this get the sense that this is where it was going? And that I literally murdered, I'm going to call it, what, maybe 20 people. Yeah, maybe 20. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't... Fine. Let's get through this. Fine.
Good, you're here. Huddle up, gang.
Is this for real?
Gang.
They want me to be a cop.
Shit. We could get a real pad. Maybe even move out of Epside? Briggs, I'm so in.
After all we've done, neon security, seriously.
You've done nothing, Vogel.
I don't see why not. Do you really think anyone cares who stabs who in Epside? What's your take?
I couldn't fucking care less. It's a chance to get out of Epside, take it. I can't believe how corrupt security is. That is literally something I would never say.
It's almost... Anyone object to going for the deal? This is your chance. No one? Good. Really good. I'll give Owen the news.
He's standing 10 feet from me, homie. He knows. This. He can hear
Whatever
you talking.
God or gods we please to get you to help us. No.
So long, then.
Same to you. It looks like the strikers are retiring. And here's your cut.
So for all that, I got 100 XP and a level 5 pistol. Because quests don't scale. But that's the voice. No, the voice acting is really good. I will give them the VAs do good work. Okay. You gotta remember, Jayhawk. Okay. You could be the best chef in the world. Okay. But if someone hands you a turd and two slices of bread, it's really difficult to make anything but a shit sandwich out of it. Okay. So the VAs are doing what they can with what they've been given. The problem's not the VAs. Okay. The NPCs look so weird. Yeah, I can't look at them. I still can't look at them. So that was the entire thing. I cleared the gangs out. I killed the disciples. I turned gang members into cops for some reason. Security, I guess, for some reason. And that's it. That's the quest. 100 XP, which is less than I get for shooting a grub on a level 75 planet. No recognition that I'm walking backwards in front of her. Just cringe nose. Yeah. They're doing the best what they can. And there's you. Glassy-eyed rubbery-faced animatronic stuff. So yeah, what did he get? I got a pistol. New items. This epic pistol I picked up from the dead guy is better than the pistol I got from the main guy, and it's 5 damage. It's literally a level 1 pistol. So if you ever do, if you play this game, and you do want to do the this quest, do it early, because it doesn't scale. It doesn't scale. Next level dialogue. Yeah, next level. All right. It's next level. All right. It's next level, and it puts location the constant, which is bugged. Don't forget that. That one's bugged too. But that's why I've got all these quests in my quest log, because I'm just like, I'm not really interested in any of this. How much burn do I have? 102. Yeah. Let's change your outfit and go exploring. Yeah, put the hazmat suit on and go to a planet. Keep comparing the DLC of, yeah, it's got, this game's strength is it has a lot of features. Yeah, it's got shipbuilding, got outpost building, it's got exploration, it's got questing, it's got this, it's got that. Okay, what it doesn't have, personal customization, rational crafting, it doesn't have tools that explorers use, like a legend, a codex, an index, any sort of thing that says, here's all the planets you've explored, here's all the shit you found on them. Doesn't have that. Doesn't even let me label the stars in the galaxy map. Doesn't have any indicators, no filters, no nothing. Yeah? It's like, it's got all the basic features at a basic level. Yeah? It does everything pretty good, but no one thing well. And I'm gonna go back to, and now, right, I'm in Neon, right? Solve the gang problem, talk to the captain of the cops or whatever the fuck. If I go back to him and talk to him, he won't remember a single fucking thing I did. He won't even know who I am. He won't even pretend to know who I am. You're like, okay, I did burn, right? Yeah, we did burn. I'm down here somewhere. I was doing folk call, but that's an abandoned, that's an empty system. I'm not really a fan of it. Surma? Yeah, let's go back to Surma. What the hell? Let's do that. So now I leave town. Okay. So there we are. Let me reset my power because they haven't fixed that bug yet either. It's only been 2 months though. But yeah, like for instance, you know, people were talking about players who've been playing for like 20, 30, 40 hours will all say, what the fuck is going on with this economy? Are they ever going to balance the economy to make the economy make sense? In order for them to make the economy make sense, they'd have to have an economy. It just seems to be a bunch of numbers input on a spreadsheet that they just said, well, it just feels like it should be worth this much, and we'll just do that. Okay. You'll notice I haven't captured any ships in a while, because I don't find capturing ships to be rewarding, a rewarding endeavor. It's not fun. It's fun. It was fun the first couple times where I was like, yeah, this is fucking cool, whatever. But it costs so much to register a ship to be able to sell it, that it's literally not worth the time it takes to capture a ship. Because it's not worth it. I mean, you literally clear a POI, you can make 5 times what you make trying to capture and sell a ship. And on top of that, you need to have the seed money, you need to have the initial investment to be able to register it in the first place. It's just this half-baked, half-assed, not totally thought through, what's the player going to do with this? It's just like, okay, we have ship design, cool. What's the next bullet point on the checklist? And it's like, you need to have more than that. So, jack of all trades, master of none. Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. Don't think I will say they can't fix a no character or story that people are invested in. A lot of people get invested in the Constellation story. Out Jayhawk. I will take issue with that. Because I read the threads on the subs, right? I see how the pulse of the game is going, whatever the fuck. And a lot of people get really invested in those Constellation NPCs. I don't know what that means. Maybe standards are lower. Maybe they never played video games before. Maybe they only played one game. Maybe they only played mobile games. Whatever. But people do get invested in this story. I personally don't know how. What kills me is when they say, oh my god, this game's writing is so amazing. Have you ever seen better writing? And I'm like, if you think this game's writing is the best you've ever seen, I would recommend reading a book. Any book. Just any book. Read some Heinlein. Read some Asimov. Read some Arthur C. Clarke. Read some Ian Banks. Read some Dan Simmons. Read some Bradbury. Read some. Read something. You know. Don't just sit on TikTok all day long. It's just baffling to me that they think that people. There's people out there who non-ironically call this good writing. I'm just like. I mean, read a comic book, dude. Read a graphic novel. Read The Watchmen, dude. Okay, there's a ship touching down, right? I am about 150 meters away from it, but I can't see what it is. Right? There's a ship landing site. There you go, Glantry. If you're watching this later, we'll be down here for 45 seconds. Now, I know from having seen it a bunch of times that that is a Crimson Fleet ghost. And at this level, it's probably a ghost core. Am I going to capture it? No. It's not worth my time. I have a job to do. I'm out here exploring, man. I'm looking for the stuff on this planet, which I find amazingly entertaining. I will say the wellness, is it wellness? Fitness. The fitness trait, if you're an explorer type, is really good. That's a Crimson Fleet ghost core. See, I called it. I know what it is. Playing No Man's Sky and say the story is the best, deepest part of the game. It's, I will say that this story is better than No Man's Sky's. Yeah. No Man's Sky's, I wouldn't call No Man's Sky's a story. I would call No Man's Sky's a narrative framework. It's words in a theme designed to explain why the game is the way it is. And in that respect, it's remarkable. It does a really good job. As a story, oh, it's so deep. Oh, the philosophical concepts. Man, have you been to high school? Okay, so we're not gonna. Oh, there they are. Okay, good. So now we're gonna shoot these motherfuckers. If I weren't such a crappy shot, this would go a lot faster, but. And there's another thing. I'm in a level 75 system. Why is there a level 6 guy running around? Okay, up it goes, and out it goes, right? Three guys dead, and the ship just leaves. So here's a little here's a little funny thing I found out the other day, completely by accident. If you go on a ship, like say right here, right now, right? There's these three guys running around loose on the ground. The landing party, we'll call them, okay? The ship lands, the bay opens up, the landing party comes out, right? Cool. If you kill the landing party, the ship will take off and leave. Right? Okay. So instead of killing the guys outside, what you do is you run straight for the door and get on the ship. Sometimes the ship will take off, sometimes it will stay on the ground. If you run inside the ship, murder everybody on board, the captain, all the crew members, everybody there, you murder everybody, take all their shit, empty the captain's locker, empty the cargo hold, you say, I'm going to take all your fucking loot. And you don't take off, you leave. Right? You get out of the ship, the landing crew is still there, you murder them all. What happens next? As we've seen, if you kill the landing party, the ship will take off. But Sar, you just went on board and killed the entire crew. The ship can't take off. You'd think. But if you go inside and kill all the crew, come outside and kill the landing party, the ship will take off. How? You'd have to ask somebody with a different grip on reality than me, man. Because I'm of the mind, maybe they got AI. I couldn't tell you, man. I couldn't. I don't know. But that's the primitiveness of the game. The game says if you kill the landing party, the ship will take off. No other conditions, no other extenuating circumstances, no other variables, no other logic. If you kill the crew and the ship, if you kill the landing party and the crew is dead, the ship is not going to take off. It's kind of odd, pretty, that animation. Yeah, the ship's taking off animation and the ship's landing animation's cool as fuck. The ship building in general, is about 88-90% of the way there. It's really good. It's good for people who like to exercise their creative urges building ships. Now, myself personally, I'm very much a function over form kind of player, and I don't find entertainment in simply designing ships. Yeah? Because I build my ships. Ships have a purpose. They have a function, right? So I'm like, okay, I need to build the ships to that function. I don't care what they fucking look like. If I can make them pretty, sure, that'd be great, but that's not the highest priority. And since your cargo goes with you in every ship that you make, and combat is basically the same regardless of your ship type, as long as your mobility stat is high and your damage output is high and your shield is high, you could be flying a bag of sand and it would be the same as flying Battlestar Galactica. It doesn't matter, right? So you're not incentivized, if you're a practical kind of person, you're not incentivized to, what do I need to find? What's the last thing I need to find? Probably a gas, right? Yeah, chlorosilanes, okay. So we're looking for a big blob on the ground. So when I build a ship, right? I build the ship, and I fiddle with it till it's got the crew compartments I need. I fiddle with it till it's got the habs I need for the passengers that I want. I make sure it's got enough firepower, got enough shields, got enough engines. At that point, I'm done. I'm just like, I'm done. My ship is done. I don't need another ship. Oh, but you could make other cooler looking ships. I could, but who's going to see it, dude? If I don't stream it, nobody cares. It's a single player game. So, this looks like Death Stranding, but more. I never played Death Stranding. But you do a lot of running around. Yeah, you do a lot of running around. I find this peaceful. I mean, we're running 1,300. We're running 1.3 kilometers to the next outpost that I've probably fucking seen. It's fun to me just looking around at this. At the music softly playing. Sitting here on this barren fucking 350 degree rock. And it's just me out here, baby. It's me and the rocks. There's no life here. There's nothing out here. I appreciate empty planets. I mean, it's fun going to temperate planets with life on it, because there's plenty of shit to find, you know, plenty of XP. All kinds of good shit comes from there. It is right there. Perfect. But I find this relaxing. Just jumping around, looking at the planet, you know? Now, the unfortunate part is, I know I'm not going to find anything that the game hasn't marked for me, you know? Like that natural thing there, this industrial thing here, and this cave over here. I know that between me and that, there's nothing but rocks. There's no random stuff. Oh, the music's actually pretty good. I just keep it low because it's weird to have it high, because the combat music is obnoxious. It's like playing the Doom music when you watch a couple of toddlers wrestle in a crib. You're like, one of these things doesn't really fit here. Yeah. But I got the music pretty low. I got it down to like 40 out of 100. But seriously, dude, it's like the only thing they fear is you. And you see a couple of toddlers in a crib going, you're like, you know, nah, not really. I mean, maybe yakety sax, sure, but. Okay. Okay, what is this? Radio tower, science outpost, industrial outpost, pipeline. What is this? Pipeline. This is pipeline. I'm going to say abandoned pipeline substation. Pipeline. Terminus! It's a terminus, guys. What's a terminus? I know what a terminus is, but what's a terminus? Pipeline terminus. It's a pipeline terminus. Guess it could be about to run spell checker or no, huh? I don't think terminus is a fucking word. Okay, so here's the robots, right? They're calm. They're cool. They won't do a thing. If you approach the door, they'll aggro, right?
Research data shows human health and productivity to be severely compromised. Human removal protocols have greatly increased efficiency and safety.
See, right? Warning, organic life form, blah, blah, blah. Every single one of these where the robots are talking like that, saying stay away from the site, there's always a terminal inside. You can disable them. Done. Now they're dead. Yeah. Right? So now all the robots just died. They all just killed over outside. Now I can live. I mean, I could have shot them, too. There's no bounty for shooting them or anything like that, so who cares? But there will be a body up here. Right? Is there a body up here? Yeah, there's a body up here. Do you have anything I want there? And then there's going to be a body. I think it's over here. Is it around the backside? Yeah, there he is. Two corpses, same place every time. Yeah. All you can take is their fucking money. You can't take their spacesuits. Okay, so it's just as a reminder, this is Surma 2, planet down the lower left. No oxygen, 0.8 G, 351 degrees. It is 351 degrees out here. Huh? 351 degrees. At night, because the temperature is the same day or night. That's one of them detailed things that's like, if you cared about your fucking game, you would make it hotter in the daytime and colder at night. That would make it at least interesting. But their temperature system is a lot like, okay, picture Earth, right? What you do is you look at Earth and you take all of its various places and you average out its temperature. So the average temperature on Earth is like 62 degrees, right? Let's say it's 62 degrees, just for the state argument. 62 degrees. If you go to a planet that has an average temperature of 62 degrees, it will be 62 degrees everywhere on that planet. If you go to a tropical biome, it will be 62 degrees. If you go to the frozen North Pole, it'll be 62 degrees. If you go to the savannah, 62 degrees. If you're there at nighttime, 62 degrees. If you go in there in the daytime, 62 degrees. Scalding thunderstorm, guess what? It's still 62 degrees. And like here, right? This thing's open to the air, okay? It is 351 degrees. This sandwich looks fine, doesn't it? This sandwich looks great. I mean, we've been baking it at 350 degrees for probably 7 months, but it's still fresh. How many preservatives you got in that motherfucker, dude? 96 on Christmas Eve. Yeah, it's, well, we're going to get that down here in San Antonio for sure. But it's like living in Australia, I guess, yeah? So yeah, pipeline Temenus, got a misspelling. 351 degrees with an intact sandwich, because who cares? And it's like, did you think players weren't going to notice the shit? Oh, and for some reason, I don't have a helmet on. More bugs, I guess. 0% oxygen? No problem. I'm an explorer, man. I'm a fucking badass. So now I'm going to quick save before we go back to the ship, right? So I don't lose my progress. Because when I fast travel back to the ship, it's going to autosave. And I don't want it to crash when I get there. And if it does, I won't lose that much. Do you plan on surveying all systems? I had planned on that, Paul, yes. I had planned on doing it. But I've gotten to... Let's see. I have visited all the systems to get the achievement. I've scanned 1,500 planets. I've surveyed 573. I've landed on almost 400. Okay. The reason fully surveyed is higher than planets landed on is because when you scan gas giants, they kind of survey it. You can't land on them. So, in essence, I probably have, what, another 1,000 planets to do? I don't think I'm going to. Is there no sun? Well, no, it's overcast right now. I mean, Venus is hot and overcast too, so that makes sense. Some of the stuff makes sense. Plus, it's nighttime. It might be nighttime. And if the planets do rotate, and they are consistent. They rotate and revolve like they should. Yeah. You see that a lot. You'll notice that the most when you're going back to... When you're going back to Jemison. Give me a shit. Crimson Fleet Ghost Fort. Okay. This is a nice touch. Remember when I was down on the planet just now? And I killed the crew and that ship took off? This is that ship. They lifted off and they waited for me in orbit. That's kind of cool. Because this is the same ship. But this has happened before. So I'm pretty confident in saying that is something that actually happens. And now, if we look at the planet... There may be... No, there isn't. Okay. Sometimes when you blow up a ship, there will be a new POI marked as a spaceship debris. And that's pretty cool too. You need a new game. Yeah, I know. I know. I need money though, dude. I might go back to Cyberpunk though. I'm definitely going back to 76. And No Man's Sky apparently dropped. They've been updating their internal branch this week, so that usually means an update is coming. Such one running from the old days. I mean, there are moments of brilliance in this game, Jayhawk. There are absolutely moments of brilliance in this game. The Vanguard quest line, absolutely. There is so much in the Vanguard quest line that is so fucking cool. And Entangled, the quest Entangled, amazing. I mean, it's reminiscent of Dishonored and Titanfall, but the implementation is good. It was really good. Abandoned farm, mining outpost, and... So I've been on this planet? Did I go to the abandoned farm? I don't remember. It does have its moments. It's just they're too few and far between. Okay, so we're going to go... First thing we do is we let this off. We look to see if this has an ocean. It does not appear that it has an ocean. It does. But there is no fauna in the ocean, so we can skip the ocean. We're good there. The reworked perk trees. Yeah, I know. I'm thinking about it, but I'm a slow learner, Jayhawk. I'm a slow learner. And it took me a really long time to internalize how it does things. I mean, I'll probably load it up and try it out, but I have to start a new character, right? I mean, I can't play my current character. I forgot how to play it. I literally forgot how to play it. I don't know. We'll see. I just think about 2077. I can't play 2077 because I hate Keanu's. I hate Keanu's voice acting. It drives me crazy. Because it's so lifeless and dead and free inflection. It's just... Ugh. I mean, maybe that's what they were going for. Okay. So this is a temperate planet. These planets, temperate planets with water on them. They have life. They have normal looking trees. Please stand in the door so I can't get by. Thank you.
How are you?
So these planets are what No Man's Sky would call lush planets, right? They have lots of life on them. They have lots of trees. They have lots of water. They have all this kind of shit, right? I do wish I could get rid of the clutter in my ship. I do wish they would learn to put things away. These planets are the most, I guess you would say, interesting because they are the most Earth-like, I guess. They have actual trees and grass and stuff like that. Hey, Keanu. No, Keanu's a good guy, dude. He's a shitty voice actor. I ain't judging him as an actor. He's a good actor, dude. He's a good actor. He's an honest-to-God, good, genuine dude. But voice acting is a skill, man. It's not something you can just drop into. It's a skill. Yeah. And so we got 18% oxygen. Uh-oh. We're getting aggroed by a critter already, huh? All right, let's fuck him up. It's a good place to look for POIs, too, because there are more points of interest on temperate planets than any other. Hunting brain blimp. At least it's spelled right. There's another one up there. Let's scan him. And then see what over there. We don't have any traits on this planet, which is okay. We have a science structure at 89. Mining platform. The mining platform, Paul, can show up. Here, the mining platform can show up on planets that have pre-marked areas. Let me show you. I even found one in a low-level system. But if you go to a system, right? Have I 100%ed that one? No. If you go to a system, right, and you see the dots on the planets, there's none here. That's an empty system. We'll go to ZeoFuge. You see what's here. But if you go to a planet and you see the dots, right? Every planet with those little dots has pre-set markers on it. And you can look and see those markers. There's a deserted relay station, and there's a science outpost. So what you can do if you want to find one, the abandoned mining platform can appear as one of these preset markers. I saw a couple of them the other day. But you scroll around the planet with the dots on it, and you look and see what it is, and it'll tell you what it is. That's how I found the deserted Freestar Collective Garrison, which was one of the coolest fucking places I've been. But you can sit here in the galaxy map and scan planets looking for the one you want. Because the abandoned mining platform can, in fact, appear on the scans. Generally doesn't appear on temperate planets, Landing area explorer, landing, that's a crash site, okay. Trying that to random landings, yeah, you would suggest 2.0. I will definitely be thinking about checking it out. But the mining platform, I mean, it might be level locked for my, it might be level locked, like it won't appear until you're a certain level. We have a bird, oh no, what the hell is that? Flocking earbat grazer? Look at you, little man. Where you at? See what you look like here. Look at the little sail fin on him. How you doing, little buddy? You're easy to spot in the grass, that's for damn sure. Alright. Now, think about flocking. The thing about flocking and swarming creatures is if you shoot one, everybody in the vicinity will come on over. So you want to do XP farming, man. Look for flocking and swarming. Hunting brain blimp up there. Okay. Hunting means they'll hunt you down. They will attack you if they get close. Fearless, yeah. Fearless, territorial, and there's another word for them. And there he goes. All right, there's four. Cool. Now go look for rocks and trees. You're 161. You haven't visited your POI. I don't know if I have or not. I found a list on that Inara site, but the list they had of POIs included things like the geophysical features. So I took all those out, and there were some other ones that they did not have. So I added them to my list. I have a spreadsheet, of course I do. And right now, there are something like 125 of them, 125 random POIs. And I've seen 90 of them. I saw four last week, which was an incredibly high number. Normally, I don't see any in any given week. I don't see any new ones. I've seen them all, you know. But I'm getting to the point now where I can recognize some of them from like 2 kilometers away. I literally don't have to go close to them. So this is mining, right? Here's a mining one. We got 0.3 AG. It's 200 away, but it's raining. Let's zoom out here. See what we got. Collapse. It's a collapse mining site. I can tell you right now. I know exactly what it is. Seen it before. They're all the same. And they all have a. Apparently the terrain is part of the POI. Because if you go, if you're looking around, this is a collapsed dig site or something, right? Collapse something. Okay, hunting brain blood. Collapsed, what, come on. There's a body here. Collapse mine, yeah. There's a body here. Don't get salty. I just keep hoping to see. Basically, I play the game, I explore to see if I can see a POI that I haven't seen before. And we're getting to the point now where it's virtually impossible. It's extremely unlikely that I will see one I've not seen before. And I've been playing 76 again, waiting for the new season to start, which should be in a couple of weeks because they're talking about releasing Atlantic City in December. So that means, what do you need, carbolixic and aluminum? Okay. So I'll probably do my season 15 scrub and start to play that again. But this game is good to relax with, yeah? It doesn't require a lot of thought. It doesn't really demand much of you. You don't have to have a lot of skill. And it's manageable, you know? Jump back on 76 trying to finish the season. Nice! Yeah, I always play it till I finish the season and I'm out. I'll go back to do other things. Like, it's mutated weekend this weekend, so... I go in there and try and find... the hell is a red dot over here? I go and try and find the plans for Garnet that I don't have. Are you in the air? That is a corpse.
Where are you at? You're over there. Ah, there's somebody over there. Okay, we got that now. Oops, the blue.
But yeah, I finished the season, God, super fast. 4 weeks this time, 5 weeks, Okay, that gantry tells me it's an unfinished hangar or a construction site. Calling it right now, guys. We see it. It's what? 300 meters away in the rain? I'm like, yeah, it's unfinished hangar or construction site. There's all my resources. I got all the flora and I need all the fauna. But I got the brain blimps and I got the little sail guys, so I don't know who the next thing is. Probably a scavenger. Alright. So what is this? Unfinished hangar? Or construction site? Unfinished hangar. Gotta be. Unfinished hangar, Johnny, tell him what he won. <sighs> 300 meters away. 1,000 feet away in the rain, and I know what this place is. And I know exactly where everything is. Now see, when you come to these places, right, there's three or four different potential scenarios. One, it's got enemies in it. Spacers, ecliptic, or pirates. Two, it has colonists, but they're dead. This is one of those. Colonists, but they're dead. Three is colonists, but they're alive. Four is colonists, but they're dead, and the robots have taken over. And then there's a fifth, there will be a bounty hunter here. Those are your five possible encounters. Some places won't have them. Like civilian outposts, they're always alive. They're always alive, and they always have missions. Somebody told me you could buy slates off them that had like information about rocks. Oh, there, see, it's a scavenger. I told you it was a scavenger that I was missing. Worm geophage. I love the little geophage creatures. Some of them are freaky as fuck, man. You go to a primordial planet, you see the creepy fucking shit there, dude. See, look at this little guy, though. He looks like one of them potato bugs, man. And he's just cruising. He's like, I'm going for good. But see, this is a planet where evolution has had a little bit of a chance to do its magic, yeah? You go to primordial planets, yeah? If you see a planet with like less three or fewer creatures and no fauna, and it says primordial, okay? You're gonna see shit like this, okay? You're gonna see little alien fucking chest burster looking motherfuckers that have a halo around them, yeah? Or you'll see predators that look like this motherfucker. I'm like, oh no, we're not playing. This guy's about 8 feet tall, man. These things are no joke. Those are, I love the primordials because you get some really freaky shit out there. The freakiest shit this game pretty much has to offer. Okay, there's some more scavengers over there. We're going to get our scavengers. Hey, buddy. And you? And come on, there's a bunch of you over here. Look at you all over here. Guess what? Found something good to feed on. And there we go. Biome complete, right? So now I have a choice. I can leave because I know. I can leave because I need to go to the next biome to get my other flora. Right? I've discovered every animal on this planet. But there's also a point of interest over there that I could potentially. Oh, and by the way, I got 192 experience for killing this guy. Yeah? And then they're roaring at me. That's okay, guys. I'm not after you. Don't worry. You're fine. So I got almost 200 experience for killing that dude, but I only got 100 experience for solving the gang war problem. Okay. Tell me which is more worthy of my time. This is what? Aluminum? No. What is that? Yeah, it's aluminum. Looks like a critter. Okay, and this, I feel like I should know what this is. Need a pet bug like that. Yeah, I know, you can't tame critters at all here, though. I mean, you can sort of if you build like an animal husbandry thing. And, oh, that's a sloop? Varun lit me, huh? Okay, Varun here. Time to kill some motherfuckers. What is this? Satellite relay. Okay, so there's a Varun Litany and Varun Zealots here, but there's spacers here. How are you alive, homie? Why didn't the Varun kill you, dude? They're right fucking there. Maybe they got the same aggro range as everybody else does. Look at this. They stood there and the spacers was right there. What the hell, dude? But they aggro on me. Yeah, I'm just playing with you now. Bad time to get lost, friend. And here goes the combat music. I'm just like, whatever. I will say Varun are a pain in the ass because they shoot you with EM weapons and it makes your vision go all fucky. And it's like, it's kind of hard to see. But thankfully I have the recon sight that marks targets. So I ain't got to worry about it so much. Okay, killed you assholes. This thing's dead. There's one over here, I thought. Didn't I kill one over here? Yeah, there he is. But see, now the ship stays on the ground, right? You're like, why is the ship still on the ground? I guess all the crew got off that time. Wait a minute. Superior Varun pack? What are the stats on that bad boy? 66 for a superior pack. Whatever. Rockefeller jank. Shit loot, brother. Check it out now. Gives you that robo brain vision, right? Okay, let's see here. Where's the... There it is. Take some emergency kits out of there. It's a pretty cool looking ship here, though. I mean... I don't know who's selling the Varun their ships. I guess they're black because the Varun are edgy. Or something. Well, this is the bag. Using Hope Tech cockpit, huh, buddy? Fuel tanks right above the cockpit. Yeah, I can't see how that could possibly go wrong. Oh wait, that's right. This game doesn't have hit location detection, so who cares? I mean, it does if you target them in targeting mode, but it doesn't do anything effective in combat. It's in a digipick? Okay. This is a satellite relay. I gotta look that up after the stream, see if I've got this place. Seems like I should have it by now, but... Okay, I'm not an architect or anything. But I'm thinking an airlock that has a guardrail going through its seals... Probably it's not going to be as effective, maybe, as you would like. Because I know in my car, the best way to get better performance out of my engine is to poke holes in the gaskets. I mean, everybody knows. It is known. Poke holes in the gasket. Poke holes in your gaskets. Make your engine breathe better. It sure will. Gummy bugs? Yeah, I don't care. Reactive gauge? I don't care. What else is in here? Any of the good loot in here? Just a bunch of junk on the table. Don't need any of that. This is snack crackers. We don't need those. This is apple slices. We don't need those. Oddly, you don't cook with apples in this game. I haven't seen anything where you cook with apples. I'm not going to bother opening that. It's not getting anything I want in it. Okay, so a little crew quarters. Well, I guess if the thing's open in the sky, the airlock doesn't really much matter then, does it? Haha, never mind. Satellite relay, though, huh? What do we got for G's? 0.3? 0.4? Oh, we could do this. Dag's favorite part, huh? There we go. Boop. Come in, Tokyo! Alright. Well, I guess this is a good place to stop then, isn't it? Sitting up on the top of the world, baby. In the rain. And there she is, looking all badass. All right. So, with that, seemed like a good time to stop and call it. We're 5 minutes. That's not too bad. We started early, right? Which is the right button? Is it this button? No, it's not. So at this point, I want to thank y'all for stopping by, sharing your Sunday with me for the up to 3 hours, a little bit of change that you did, if you did. If you had a good time today, appreciate you clicking that like button. Feed that YouTube algorithm. Get more viewers in here to talk about this, whatever the hell is happening in here. I'm not so sure anymore. If you're new to the channel, this is the first thing you're seeing, and you like this kind of thing, click subscribe for more of this kind of thing. I stream something on Sunday starting at noon central. It's been Starfield for a little while, but it might not be next week because this game is sort of running its course. I don't really have much else to do anymore other than explore. I mean, I like it, but it's boring to watch. Yeah, and that's like, I can sit here and wax philosophical for you, but I mean, that's not really why you come here, I don't think. Listen to the old guy talk about the old days like he's some kind of wise motherfucker. It's like, yeah, that ain't how it works. So next week, it'll be something. It'll probably be 76 next week, or No Man's Sky, something different. Might be this again. I might find something that I want to explore in it, and we'll check it out again and see what's going on with it. But I mean, really, this is it, you know, really narrow on rails missions with horrible grammar usage and really disturbingly puzzling quest lines that don't make sense. Exploration, and then there's shipbuilding, which is a lot of fun. But again, I have a tough time with it because I build ships for a reason. I don't build them to make them look pretty. I build them to do a function, right? So they all tend to look the same. And it's got, I mean, you can't really be a trader because there's no real economy. You can't really be a bounty hunter. I mean, you can. You can take missions from the mission board to go to the same POIs over and over to kill the same enemies over and over. Sure, you can do that. But that gets old pretty fast too, right? There's no real smuggling. There's no real smuggling dynamic because it's so shallow and half-baked that it doesn't make sense. I mean, it's there if you want to do it, sure. Outpost building, the same thing. It's there if you want to do it, but it's not rewarding outside of just the action of doing the stuff. Have you got all legendary ship encounters? Those are random. I've done the Spacer one, and I've done the Varun one. I don't know. There's probably an Ecliptic one somewhere floating around in a star system near a system I haven't been to yet. I've done like two or three of them though. Excuse me. But I mean, all they are is just credits and loot. That's it. There's nobody knows that you've done it. You can't capture them because they're M class. So it's like, okay, well, what am I going to do with this? All the activities end up in the same unsatisfying rewards. There's no, give me a unique outfit. It doesn't have to be a combat thing, you know? Like, the best part of the Freestar Collective quest was getting those first officer uniforms. Man, those things are fucking cool. I'm like, hell yeah, give me more of those. But, I don't know, man. So anyway, we'll see. We'll see. Next week, we'll see. We'll see what kind of mood I'm in. As always and as ever, I want to thank y'all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.